2 years ago, Quinnipiac hired Baker Dunleavy to be its next men's basketball head coach. Last year, Dunleavy turned a struggling program around from the cellar of the conference standings to a team that won two games in the MAC postseason tournament. This season, the Bobcats are not only MAC contenders, but are making an NCAA tournament push as well. And today, the Bobcats host the Manhattan Jaspers in the final regular season game of the year. Pre-game, halftime, post-game, we have it all. This is Bobcat Gameday, presented by Q30 Sports, and it starts right now. Tip-off is set for 2 p.m. We'll have the broadcast of the game courtesy of the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network. But first, all the pregame coverage you need right here, right now. Let's get to a special edition. Let's get a feel for the Quinnipiac season and this Quinnipiac men's basketball team. Brian Schwartz takes us through the season that was so far for Dunleavy and the Bobcats.
They say every day is a new beginning, a new dawn. In Hampden, Connecticut, not only was 2017 a dawn, a new year, but really, a new start. And there was a new vision, and it was clear, it's time to win.
It's tipped out to the perimeter. Nelson at the buzzer, it's no good! The Bobcats pull off an incredible upset and take down Tunisia, 72-69!
And the Bobcats are going home.
If you keep good people around you that are honest with you and tell you the truth, you know, your staff, you can get better.
Fast forward to this year. Let's begin with one of the biggest games the program has ever played in. Opening up this season against the defending national champions, the Villanova Wildcats. That team Quinnipiac is trying to emulate. Baker's return to Philly wasn't the prettiest, but the Bobcats received high praise.
They're going to be good. Baker's got a good team. They got a lot of new guys they're putting together. They got good length, and I think they're going to be good.
The key missing piece for Quinnipiac that Saturday night in the city of brotherly love was Rich Kelly. The Bobcats' starting point guard would be sidelined for the first five games with an MCL sprain in his right knee. Five games later, Quinnipiac's new starting big man, Kevin Marfo, went down with a partially torn meniscus. Three games without him, 3-3 to start MAC play. Marfo returned January 25th against Marist, and he wasn't the only one to have the headlines that weekend.
Cam Young will go the other way for Quinnipiac. Young for three. There it is! Cam Young from downtown.
1,000 points. I never thought that would be something like coming from junior college, you know, having started, only having 2 years. I never thought it would be something I would get.
And then Cam Young decided this is his time to shine.
Cameron Young. He might have had the best performance of any player in a game this season. 55 for Young. Third most by a D1 player in the last 20 years, most by anybody this year.
55 points, most in NCAA Division I basketball this season. Most ever by a MAC player in a single game. MAC Player of the Week for the fourth time. And the accolades kept on coming. Everything for Young, Dunleavy, and the Bobcats is on the rise as the regular season sees its sunset. But it surely won't be the end. The postseason is coming. The sun will rise on the morning of the MAC tournament in Albany, New York soon, and it'll sure to be brighter than it ever has for Quinnipiac.
Well, Quinnipiac played St. Peter's on Friday night, so let's take a look at some of that action before we get to today's game. And you're going to see a common theme in this one, Quinnipiac hitting a lot of three-pointers all game long. So we'll take you to the first half. Quinnipiac up 14-10 at this point. Step backer from Cam Young. You guessed it, cash. Later on, in the corner, Jacob Rigoni, cash. Quinnipiac up 20-16. Ty Pickron getting in the action, cash. 28-16 Bobcats. Later in the first half, Tyrese Williams, another freshman, cash. Bobcats lead 38-30 going into the half. So we'll take you to the second half in, well, pretty much more of the same, right? Quinn Taylor down low finds Adolu. He makes the jump shot there. And now inside is Kevin Marfo. Big slam dunk there for the big guy. Rich Kelly moves the ball. Cam Young, cash. Money from downtown. Quinnipiac up 50-45. Now Young inside, dishes to Rigoni, and cash again. Rigoni finally getting hot from the three-point line as he struggled a little bit this season. And Cam Young putting his defender on skates there. My goodness, looking like James Harden on those step backs. And yep, we'll end with another one. Young this time slamming it inside. The pump fake got to him. Quinnipiac wins 77-60. And the Bobcats hit 16 threes in that entire game. All right, so let's hear from Dunleavy and some of the seniors on this Bobcast squad as they prepare for their final game here in Hamden and what these seniors have meant to this team each year they've been here.
Yeah, I think this group of guys will leave a really important legacy on our program. And for me, it's I'm really grateful for what they've contributed. They kind of like split 2 years between coaching staffs. And, you know, when you go through that experience where you got to adjust to a new staff and a new coach, you know, so much of it is all about your mindset. Are you open-minded? Are you trusting? And I've been very lucky that these guys have trusted us, our staff, and bought into what we've really preached.
It's really meant a lot for me just coming from where I started my freshman year. Won 9 games. Sophomore year, won 10 games. Junior year, won 12 games. And then finally this year, kind of breaking through and being a part of a winning team, it really means a lot just to just see all the hard work that we put in over these 4 years kind of come to fruition now and kind of be winning some games.
My mind is telling me you're going to cry. It's either before the game or after the game. It's one of the two. So I don't know. I'm just a roller coaster right now. It's been tough. Cause I just think about it, just like, it's coming to an end.
Surreal, man. You know, when we were a freshman, you hear from the seniors, oh, time flies, man, you better enjoy it. But you always see, man, I'm not hearing that. And then next thing you know, you're a sophomore. And then next thing you know, you're a junior. And then before you know it, it's senior night, you know what I'm saying? So it's just surreal, man. It's been these past 4 years just really been really amazing. And they've flown by for sure. But I just can't put into words, man. It still doesn't seem real that Sunday's going to be you know, senior night, you know, but, you know, ready for it, I guess.
I just think this class has a business-like approach. They love basketball. They spend a lot of time in the gym, and they're really coachable. You know, I think they're learners, and listeners, learners, and respectful. So I think, you know, when our young guys come into summer school last summer, they just see an atmosphere of professionalism and of respect and a great work ethic, and those guys set the tone for that.
All right, so let's get to some more of today's action. We have our own beat reporter, Josh Silverman, standing by at the People's United Center. We'll get to him in just a second. He's going to tell you a little bit about some of these seniors on this team. You just heard from him there. Aaron Robinson, Andrew Robinson, Abdullahi Bundu. So Josh is standing by at Lender Court. Josh, what can you say about these seniors?
So much behind. Now, to be honest, we're not going to mince any words. They haven't left a lot behind in terms of wins. You know, this team got their first, these seniors got their first win just in the MAC tournament last season. They've never been to an NCAA tournament, but this team still has their ending unwritten for this season. I mean, this year's team for the seniors has been the best since they've been here. And now when you look at what these seniors are able to do, you look at Cam Young, first of all, brought a national attention to a team that lacked it since he was here. You look at Abdullahi Bundu, who's played hard through every whistle, played for his teammates, done everything he could to win. And look at the Robin. Obviously, Aaron Robinson will be here next year as a graduate student. Andrew Robinson will not. But when you look at the two of them, they're always showing up with a smile on their face. And all four of them have been the epitome of what it means to wear a Bobcat uniform.
Yeah, Josh, and although, you know, you talk about these seniors too, but also they really have a living impact on the younger players on this team, and they probably kind of influence them in ways that we don't even see. But from your perspective, what's the influence been there?
Yeah, I mean, they're huge role models for this team. First of all, you look at Cam Young. He played 8 minutes his junior year, and we've talked about it, but we haven't talked about the human element of that, the human element of what it must have been like to sit on the bench knowing that you were good enough to play in the game and not going in. He could have transferred, and no one would have blamed him for transferring at the end of his junior season, but instead he was patient. He allowed Baker Dunleavy to come in with his new staff and teach Cam and give Cam the opportunity, and Cam ran away with it. So anyone on the team, anyone in sports that maybe hasn't gotten the greatest opportunity or hasn't been able to do much with it can look at Cam as an inspiration. They can look at Abdoulaye Boundou as someone who's cared about his teammates on and off the court, someone who's showed up every day, been proud to wear the uniform, and has continued to try to get wins. And they look at Andrew and Aaron as just people who are described to me as great teammates and who I know personally as great people. They're able to just look at them and see people who are just amazing people and people who I know this coaching staff is very happy to have the privilege to coach.
All right, of course, behind Josh, you can see those senior day ceremonies, so we'll toss it back up to Josh in just a few minutes. But for now, it's time to take a quick break here on the Q30 Sports Bobcat Game Day pregame show. Stay with us after the break. Welcome back. Thanks for sticking with us here on Bobcat Game Day. All right, so we heard a little bit from our beat reporter, Josh Silverman, but we also have the two broadcasters for today's game. Play-by-play is Brian Schwartz and caller Kevin Higgins. We're going to send it up to them, who are courtside at the Lender Court, to have more on this today's matchup.
All right, Kevin Higgins, I'm Brian Schwartz at the People's United Center, ready for senior day for the Quinnipiac Bobcats and Manhattan Jaspers, the final game of the season for the Bobcats. It's a big one, and the Bobcats can clinch a number two seed in the MAC tournament, which would give them the extra day off if they were to win the first game. So, Kevin, it's a big game. What players are you watching on this Bobcats team today?
Well, for Quinnipiac, I think it's Tyrese Williams. The freshman has stepped in, and listen, we all know Cam Young is going to carry the load scoring, but Tyrese Williams has done a good job averaging about 10 a game of secondary scoring, and also on the defensive end, whether it's man-to-man or helping in zone, he has such active hands and feet defensively, he's a human blanket sometimes. And for Manhattan, it's Warren Williams. Their freshman has stepped up this year with the loss of Pauly Polycap. He averages about 10 a game. He leads the team right now in scoring and is their second leading rebounder, so he's been important for them to step up this season.
Even though this Manhattan team has not had a great season, they have a lot of good young players, a lot of good freshmen. This is a team that can give Quinnipiac some problems today.
Yes, and it does start again with Warren Williams. 6'9 forward, he's a mismatch because he also has a mid-range to slight long-range shot in his game. He's going to be a real problem for people like Jacob Bergoni, Cam Young, even Bundu or Marfo because he's so versatile. And also Tyler Reynolds averages about 7 a game, good enough for a 1-2 punch. But with them, they only average about 14 a game combined. The team averages less than 60 a game. They're very stout defensively, but they need 4 or 5 guys to step up offensively if they want to have a chance today.
So Quinnipiac can clinch the number two seed with a win. Kevin, how do they do that? How do they get this victory today?
Well, I think for them, they have to go inside more. Listen, it's no secret. This team attempts 33s a game, top 10 in the country. But sometimes when it's not going in, they try to shoot their way out of a slump. That doesn't always work, and I think a change of pace offensively, we've seen in games past, guys like Abdoulaye Bundu and Kevin Marfo inside, talented post players who can fight through contact and draw fouls, and I think that is their key if they're entering a shooting slump at some point.
Quinnipiac and Manhattan will get going in just a couple of minutes, but first we'll send it back to the studio. Here's MJ Barrett.
Brian, thank you. Yep. Good luck on the call today, guys. We'll get to that game in just a few minutes as they're approaching tip-off at 2 o'clock here from Hamden. But it's time for another quick break here on the Q30 Sports Bobcat Game Day pregame show. We'll be right back. All right, Quinnipiac and Monmouth tip off at 2 p.m. But before we get to more of that game, let's talk about some of the implications for it. Have a look at the MAC standings coming into today's game. Right now, as you see, Quinnipiac, the number two seed in the conference, Iona has already locked up that top spot. So Quinnipiac cannot go any higher than two. However, they are trying to preserve that second spot. Of course, these top five teams getting a bye in the first round. As you look down the rest of it, Canisius, Ryder, and Siena round out that top five. And then Monmouth, Marist, you see Manhattan, tied for 7th place at 7-10 in conference. So they're going to look to earn a win today, kind of set up that seeding for next weekend's MAC tournament. And as you see the rest of the field play out, Niagara, Fairfield, and St. Peter's rounding out the conference. So right now, Quinnipiac at the 2 spot. They play Manhattan today, who's in that tied for 7th spot. We're going to bring in Josh Silverman once again for a little bit more on this game, more of the nitty-gritty of it, if you will. Josh, so my first question to you. right, sorry about those technical difficulties. We'll try to get Josh back as soon as we can. What we are going to move on to, though, we had an interview with Jaden Daly, covers the MAC for a couple different outlets. We talked to him on the phone earlier this week. Let's have a listen to see what he said.
Have you ever seen anything like this where it really is anyone's game winning in March?
Not to this extent. And I've put out tiebreaker scenarios for the last 3 or 4 years. I've never seen anything this complex in all my time covering the MAC, where you have so many infinite possibilities where one team could finish first and win the regular season on paper and get an NIT bid, but that same team could also finish sixth and end up playing at 10 o'clock on Thursday night in Albany.
Moving over to Quinnipiac, obviously this team, I mean, last year's team had promise and, you know, they made some noise in the MAC tournament, but this year's team is just so much better. Obviously, they're at the top of the regular season standings, and, you know, people have talked about them potentially making that jump into the NCAA tournament. What makes this year's team so much better than last year's?
The continued maturation of the upperclassmen. We knew Cameron Young was going to be special when he got the fifth year and was a preseason first teamer. I don't think any of us saw back in July and August Cameron Young averaging 26 points per game in conference play and being the surefire MAC player of the year. I don't think anybody saw Kevin Marfo being one of the leading rebounders in the MAC and giving Baker Dudley the opponent 1-2 punch inside what Abdullahi will do and allowing him to be interchangeable with his big men. I don't think anybody saw Jacob Ragone being more than just a shooter. He's evolved to be the same way that Shane Richards did his junior and senior years at Manhattan, two teams that I had the pleasure of working closely with. And that's what Ragone reminds me of. And let's not forget Rich Kelly. When he signed with Quinnipiac, he reminded me of a mid-major Ryan Archidiakono, and he continues to do that. He scores, he rebounds, he gets assists, he gets his teammates involved. If it wasn't for so many upperclassmen in front of him, he'd be a first-team All-MAC player. And if it wasn't for Siena's mobility this season and what Jamie and Christian has done, Baker Dunleavy would be the consensus coach of the year in the MAC. I think the Bobcats are formidable. I think they could be the favorite to win. Iona's recent 6-game win streak has given me second thoughts about that because you never count Tim Kloos out in March. But Quinnipiac's on my short list, that's for sure.
Do you think Cam Young finishes as the player of the year?
Absolutely. It should be unanimous in my opinion.
All right, let's look at the top five plays of the Quinnipiac men's basketball season so far. Not top five of the week, but of the whole season. We've got a lot to choose from. Cameron Young in the lane. And one. Young dropped 55 points in that game, was the first story on SportsCenter that night, and we'll see more Young in this, but this time it's Abdullahi Boundou, the slam in transition there. Quinnipiac playing Stony Brook earlier in the year. All right, play number three. Tyrese Williams drives inside, passes it out, and the good ball movement for Quinnipiac. Cam Young on the slam. Nice basket there from number one. All right, play number two of the Quinnipiac men's basketball season. Young against Villanova. Watch out, ref, because here comes Cam Young with the dunk. Aggressive 2 points there from number one. And the top play of the year for Quinnipiac men's basketball. You guessed it, Cam Young. Spin and shoot from behind the arc. A three-pointer for Young. He's been incredible this season for the Bobcats, hoping to give them a long run in the MAC tournament. All right, we got Josh Silverman back on the line. Josh up at Lambert Court. Some more technical difficulties, so we'll move on. All right, the Sports Pause Twitter poll of the week. This week, you can vote on Twitter at Q30 Sports is the following. Will both the men's and women's basketball teams win the MAC tournament? Your options, pretty simple. Yes, one of them will, or neither of them will. So, of course, both these teams playing next weekend in Albany, competing for a MAC championship, and in turn, trying to make the NCAA tournament. Let's take a look at this Sports Pause fun fact. This one, very fun. Free throw percentages. Quinnipiac, fourth in the conference with a team free throw percentage of over 70%. In fact, 71%. While Manhattan, at the bottom of the conference, with a percentage of 57 from the charity stripe. So you expect, you know, free throws may have a result in this game. Let's move on. We got some more fast facts for you. Series history between Quinnipiac and Manhattan. After Quinnipiac defeated Manhattan 63-59 in Hamden earlier this year, season series is currently tied with a record of 6-6. The winner of today's game will lead the all-time series and, of course, jump to 7-6. Let's take a look at some of the Quinnipiac seniors. After all, it is their senior day. Cameron Young, a 6'6 guard. Young's been absolutely phenomenal for the Bobcats this season. He led SportsCenter, as I mentioned earlier, and he's just been a force. Baker Dunleavy called him perhaps the most highly used player in the MAC, which is definitely something you can't contest looking at some of his different stats. Talk about those 55 points that was earlier in the year a couple weeks ago. And this is his stats from that night. 10 rebounds, so he had 55 and 10. 9 of 13 from the three-point range. 16 of 20 from the charity stripe. And overall, shot 62.5% from the floor on that night. You go back and look at some of the other seniors. You got players like Aaron Robinson and Andrew Robinson. Those two are brothers. They came into Quinnipiac together, and now they're leaving together. Aaron, kind of that sharpshooter, 3-and-D guy. Same with Andrew, if you kind of think at it. He's got that good three-point shot as well. But Andrew has been dealing with some injuries so far this year, so hasn't seen much action of late. Maybe Quinnipiac can get him going for the MAC tournament. And then the final senior, if we talk about him, is Abdullahi Bundu. I mean, you talk about a man who came to Quinnipiac and saw a whole new life, came from Sierra Leone, has played Division I college basketball, averaging 5.5 points per game and just over 5.5 rebounds as well, wearing that number 34 jersey for Quinnipiac. He's a small big, but trust me, when he wants to get big, he can. He has great ups, dunks a lot, and really just that kind of player that Quinnipiac needs, especially when you're having someone come off the bench, almost that sixth man role. All right, so we have Brian Schwartz, our play-by-play commentator, on the line. We're going to toss it up to him in just about 1 second. But first, a commercial break. We'll be right back.
today is just a culmination of the long and sometimes treacherous journey that it has been for them.
It has been, and this time around, Quinnipiac has a chance to do some damage in the MAC tournament. With a win today, Quinnipiac can clinch the number 2 seed in the MAC tournament. With a loss, they'll probably be at the number 3 seed in the MAC tournament. So either way, they have a first round bye. They will not play Thursday in Albany. They'll most likely start Friday as the number 2 seed. So Quinnipiac has the bye. They're ready for this game as they want that bye. And they want that day off Saturday if they win the first game.
Absolutely. It's vitally important. And first of all, the bye saves us some travel personally. We don't have to leave Thursday night. We can leave Friday. But this is something, I think at the beginning of the year, if you had just even told this team that they would be a 2 or a 3 seed, they would have taken it without hesitation. And as you mentioned, they want that Saturday off to make the home stretch a little easier if they were to play on Sunday and Monday.
Quinnipiac in Manhattan coming up in just a few minutes as Quinnipiac announces its starting lineup. You have the senior Aaron Robinson getting the start today. He starts alongside Cameron Young, Rich Kelly, Jacob Ragoni, and Abdulai Bundu. So you got the seniors in there, and you got the young players in Rich Kelly and Jacob Ragoni. And the standout really is Cameron Young.
Of course. I mean, he has terrorized the MAC all season long. I think he's probably hands down the best player in this conference this season. Averaged just over a shade over 23 a game. Highlighted by, nowadays it seems like we can't talk about him without mentioning the 55 that he dropped on Siena a few weeks back. But this team wins and loses as Cameron Young plays.
Starting lineup for Manhattan goes like this: Warren Williams, Nehemiah Mack, Christian Hickson, Tyler Reynolds, and Samir Stewart are the starting five. So we get set for a tip. He's Kevin Higgins. I'm Brian Schwartz. We thank you for listening to this presentation of Quinnipiac basketball on the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network. We welcome all our Q30 television viewers and listeners, and we thank everyone behind the scenes for putting together today's production. Players line up, getting set for the tip. And Abdulai Bundu will be the one to jump for Quinnipiac, and for Manhattan, it's Warren Williams, the freshman, their leading scorer.
Yeah, and he, as you mentioned, he is a freshman. It's been very impressive to watch what he's done, especially since Pauly Polycap, the reigning MAC Defensive Player of the Year and already one of the upperclassmen and leaders and leading scorer, not to mention, on this team, has gone down. Williams has really stepped up.
20 minutes on the clock, and we are set for action. The tip goes Manhattan's way. And here we go. We're off. Nehemiah Mack has the ball top of the key. He's guarded by Kelly. A screen right finds Reynolds, right wing, guarded by Ragoni. He holds the ball up high by his head. Now passes to Stewart right in front of us on the right side. Manhattan in their away green. Quinnipiac their home whites. Down low on the block, it's Williams. Gets poked in the eye. He's wincing in pain right there and holds the ball. The ball goes loose, and it's a jump ball. Jacob Ragoni and Stewart fighting for it. Possession will go to Quinnipiac.
You know what I love about jump balls? Just because the whistle blows doesn't mean you have to let the ball go. And Jacob Ragoni, even though the whistle blew a few times, refused to let go of that ball until he had to.
Ragoni, one of the key players on this team, has kind of been inconsistent to start this season. He shoots the ball well, not great defense, but he's played a lot better the last few games of the season.
He's a microwave shooter, he really is. And when he's feeling it, he adds a third or fourth option to a team that's already deadly beyond the arc.
Rich Kelly takes the ball up, almost goes back court on that, and now gets it past the line. Cam Young with the ball top of the key finds Kelly now. Left wing, Kelly guarded by Stewart. Kelly right-handed dribble, gets a screen right from Bundu. Switch to Williams. Mismatch down low. Bundu inside gets the layup.
And that's a nice start to Abdulai Bundu's senior day. Nice feed there, an easy layup for him.
Rich Kelly with great vision, and that's what this sophomore guard does well, and that's what Quinnipiac missed without him earlier this year when he missed 5 games. Here's Nehemiah Mack, top of the key, guarded by Kelly. A screen left, moves left, now switch to Young. A screen from Williams. Mack takes a 3, and that one's good. Now, and Manhattan's got a 3-2 lead.
Manhattan, not the best 3-point shooting team. They shoot 33.7%, so it would be great for them if players like Mack could step up and make those buckets.
Good defense here by Mack, really trying to contain Kelly. Aaron Robinson gets it, now Kelly. Here's Cam Young by the Manhattan bench. Pump fake, drives inside, kicks it out to Robinson. Now Kelly, left wing. Screen from Bundu again, but instead finds Young. Back to Kelly, a 3. That one's too strong off the back of the iron, and Manhattan comes back the other way. It's Christian Hinkson. Hinkson takes it all the way up himself. Now by the free throw line. Into the low block. Williams puts up the shot over Boondu. No good. Rigoni comes soaring in for the rebound. And Quinnipiac has possession.
That didn't fall for them, but I think that's exactly what Manhattan wants, to get the ball in there to Williams, and he got a good look at it, just didn't go in.
2 minutes into the game, Rigoni pump fakes into Young for the in the corner. Young, right-handed dribble back out for Kelly. They'll reset. Robinson. And now Rigoni and Cam Young. He's got an open three, passes it up. Finds Kelly in the corner, a three. That one's no good. Rich Kelly 0 for 2 beyond the arc so far. Manhattan leads it 3-2. Coming back up quickly. Stewart to Mack. And Mack will slow things down. Manhattan gets set in their offense. Inside to Williams. He's calling for it. Far block. Now kicks it back out to Mack. Inside to Williams, and Cam Young comes away with the interception. Young slows things down now. Top of the key. Finds Aaron Robinson. Rigoni in the corner. Pump fakes. Hinkson right on top of him. Aaron Robinson back for Rich Kelly. Kelly slowing things down. 16 on the shot clock. Rigoni drives inside. No foul call. Misses the layup. Goes out of bounds, and it'll stay with Quinnipiac.
Williams actually almost blocked that one into his own net. Came up from behind on Rigoni and smacked that off the rim.
Tyrese Williams checks in for Quinnipiac. Aaron Robinson will take a seat.
And a little note here, as it seems like Manhattan's going to go with a zone. I think that's probably smart on Coach Steve Masiello's part, because Quinnipiac is such a quick team and they utilize the pick and roll pretty well. I think it's smart to go with a zone look. And as I say that, it looks like maybe they've shifted to man-to-man.
Cam Young, step back jumper. That one's no good. Rigoni gets the offensive rebound. Abube checked in for Manhattan on that last possession. Here's Rich Kelly driving inside. Finds Boondu on the interior. Layup, and that's good.
Well, Boondu, obviously all 4 points early, and we both know how hard it is to drive in on Abube. Abube, such a tough defensive force, and Boondu did a good job to get around him there.
4-3 lead for Quinnipiac, 16:30 to go in the first half. Manhattan gets set. Reynolds back for Mack. Mack at the top, screen right from Abube. Mack with the three, rolls out, and Boondu comes soaring in for the rebound.
And as it seems like they have Mack kind of pressing the ball a little bit, I think that's smart, again, just to waste time off the clock and make Quinnipiac work for it on the offensive end.
Boondu kicks it out to Rigoni, far corner. His three is short, and Abube gets the rebound. Mack back up the other way. 4 minutes into this game, a one-point lead for Quinnipiac early on. Manhattan into the corner. Reynolds, an open three. That one's no good, but Abube gets the offensive rebound. Here's Nehemiah Mack driving in on Rigoni. The ball comes loose, and Boondu finds it. And here's Rich Kelly coming back the other way for Quinnipiac. Finds Tyrese Williams in the corner. He drives baseline. Baseball pass to Cam Young, but he stepped out of bounds.
I think they actually called the charge on Williams.
There's a charge on Williams. So Manhattan will get the ball when we come back from this timeout. 15:33 to go in the first half. Quinnipiac leads it 4-3. You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network.
There are those who dedicate themselves to a sense of honor, to a life of courage, and a commitment to something greater than themselves. They have always defended this nation and each other. They still do. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Okay, what are you wearing right now?
Nothing.
That's right. So mommy's going to teach you how to dress yourself. Underwear always comes first, name tag at the back, then pants, then shirt. Get the first button in the right hole or you have to start all over. Socks going first, then shoes, right on right, left on left. With shoelaces, just take the ends, cross them over, switch the loops, the rabbit goes down the hole, pull tight, and you're left with bunny ears. Got it? Why are your pants on your head?
Most parenting is hard to do in just 2 minutes. But 2 minutes twice a day, making sure they brush their teeth, is easier, and it could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain. Visit 2min2x.org to find out more. A message from the Partnership for Healthy Mouths, Healthy Lives, and the Ag Council.
Every day, the men and women of the United States Marine Corps demonstrate their commitment to defend the American way of life. Since 1775, wherever the mission takes us, we always remember the land we call home. As Marines, we take a stand for our nation, for us all. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Hey, it's Emma Spagnolo, General Manager of WQAQ. Are you looking for a fun and creative way to get the word out about your business while trying to appeal to a young group of college students? Well, look no further. WQAQ is Quinnipiac University's student-run radio station. Here at WQAQ, we allow businesses of all kinds to advertise.
This is Abdullah Rundu. You're listening to Quinnipiac Bobcat Basketball on WQAQ 98.1 FM QBSN, Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network.
Quinnipiac up 4-3 on Manhattan. We welcome you back to the first half on the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network. Out of the timeout, a quick three from Manhattan. That's Tyler Reynolds.
And Reynolds has been asked to kind of shoulder the load since Polycap went down for Manhattan, so it's important to see him heat up early.
Quinnipiac now with the ball down 6-4. Travis Atson entered the game for the Bobcats. He kicks it out to Kelly, who drives in and finds a hole in the defense for the easy layup.
He's so quick. That was just such a quick pump fake, and then immediately off the dribble just flew to the rim there.
Stewart inside to Reynolds. Abube fakes the three, now gives it to Reynolds. Screen for Reynolds, and he'll take a three. That one's no good, and Rich Kelly gets the rebound around Abube. Tyrese Williams on the baseline. Kicks it out to Atson. Corner three. That one's good. And the Bobcats take the lead.
Travis Atson give you a little bit of everything. He has lane from just about any part on the court. Three is not his most comfortable shot, but he can go out there and hit it if he wants to, and he just did.
And he's a key part of this Bobcats team because he's not played to what Quinnipiac thought he would, obviously coming off an ACL tear last year. Bobcats get a steal. Tyrese Williams with the pick. And he'll give it to Cam Young. Young drives inside. Kicks it back out to Rich Kelly. A deep three rolls out. And Travis Atson will corral the offensive rebound. So Quinnipiac gets a new shot clock. Cam Young top of the key guarded by Stewart. Tyrese Williams now left wing. Now Rich Kelly on the other side. Manhattan staying in their zone. Getting into Atson. Low block. Back out to Williams. 15 on the shot clock. Williams screen left from Bundu. Back out for Young. He takes a three. He's fouled. The shot doesn't fall, but Cam Young will have three from the free throw line.
Well, it's been about 6 minutes, so we usually expect Young to have about 14 to 20 points at this point in the game. But it's important for him to, and listen, we all know that Cam Young is never afraid to pull the trigger. But I want to talk about Rich Kelly for a second. He's 0 for 3 from 3 right now. I think this is a big moment for him to see if he's going to continue to keep shooting from out there or not.
Young hits the first, and it's big for the Bobcats because Rich Kelly is one of their best three-point shooters. He's one of the best three-point shooters in the entire conference.
He really is, and he's such a versatile offensive player as Young hits the second. We just saw him go to the rack a few minutes ago. He's a great passer, leads the team in assists, averages about 5 a game. He can shoot from anywhere on the court. And so we talked before the game about how Tyrese Williams can provide secondary scoring, and that's true, but Rich Kelly is really the other go-to guy on this team.
Cam Young hits them all from the free throw line, so the Bobcats are up 12-6. Kevin Morfo checks into the game for Abdullah Bundu. His first action of the day for Manhattan. Elijah Buchanan comes into the game, as well as Tekai Green. Williams on the inside gets the layup and the foul, and Manhattan will have a chance for a three-point play.
I was very interested to see how the Williams and Morfo matchup would go here down low, and it looked to me anyways like Williams hooked out of the way a little bit before getting into that layup. Morfo not happy with the call, but regardless, great finish there from Warren Williams.
Warren Williams averaging 8.4 points per game. Probably the most outstanding player on this Manhattan team this season. His free throw rolls out, but coming inside for the offensive rebound is Nehemiah Mack.
Total lapse defensively there by Quinnipiac. Atson and Morfo unsure of who had who on the rebound in there.
So Manhattan gets the extra possession. Inside for Williams, guarded by Morfo. Now into the corner, it's Green. Also into the game is Samson Usillo. Williams puts a layup up, and it goes off the backboard and out. And Morfo gets the rebound. Quinnipiac possession. Cam Young takes a long three, and he hits. Cam Young just took that three from Los Angeles.
There are very few people in, I don't even want to say the MAC, in the country that can hit that shot, and Cam Young is one of the few.
Cam Young has two NBA scouts here today, we have heard, and I'm sure they like that because that was NBA range.
And then some.
Cam Young literally hit that, if you're familiar with the Quinnipiac court, where it says People's United Center in front of the Manhattan bench, it's probably by the R in the center.
It's very far away for those of you listening at home. It was a very, very, very far away shot.
So Manhattan will inbound as the ball went out of bounds. And they cannot inbound. 5 seconds goes by, and Quinnipiac will get the ball. Coming back in for Manhattan is Samir Stewart. And Nehemiah Mack will take a seat. 15-8, Quinnipiac leads Manhattan. 12:44 to go in the first half. Cam Young will inbound with a press from Manhattan. And Young will be pressured by Stewart. Finding Tyrese Williams. Williams gets it past the half-court line. Finding Travis Atson. Cam Young, about the same spot, pumps, doesn't take it. Now Travis Atson will take a three. That one's too strong. The rebound rolls around, and Warren Williams takes control. Manhattan coming back the other way. An alley-oop attempt to Sillo. It goes right through his hands and into the Quinnipiac cheerleaders on the baseline. Quinnipiac ball.
Those are two straight careless turnovers by Manhattan, and for a team that struggles to score, averaging about 56 a game, every possession counts, and you really can't afford sloppiness like that.
Quinnipiac inbounds Tyrese Williams to Cam Young. Now Young splits the defenders as he moves quickly up the court. He's double-teamed, gets it to Tyrese Williams, top of the key, slowing things down. Young, a pump fake, driving inside, putting up a layup, and he shoves Warren Williams down to the ground. Well, it'll be an offensive foul on Cam Young.
That's the second early charge that Manhattan has drawn, and as poor as they've been offensively this season, they're a very stout defensive team, only average about 63 points per game allowed, and you've seen it here, great positioning and great footwork defensively.
15-8, Quinnipiac leads, 12 minutes to go in the first half. A double screen, Stewart moves right, now goes left. In the corner, it's Usillo. Usillo drives in and hits a floater.
Good shot there by Usillo. And as Manhattan continues to press here, Steve Masiello is one of the better coaches in this conference. Back-to-back MAC champions in 2014 and 2015. He knows his team struggles offensively, and he knows how to coach them up defensively like this.
Thomas Capuano also checked in for Manhattan. Tyrese Williams attempts a crazy layup. He's fouled, and it doesn't go in. But that was a very nice try there by Tyrese Williams.
It was a hook and a windmill all in one.
We'll take a break because there's a timeout on the floor. 11:30 to go in the first half. Quinnipiac leads it 15-10.
The young men and women who become United States Marines come from our hometowns to become a part of something greater than themselves. This commitment represents the highest level of steadfast allegiance to the betterment of our communities, our country, and our Marine Corps. The journey will be one of the most challenging, but also one of the most rewarding. The few, the proud, the Marines.
So you see, son, good manners are important. Should I go through it again?
Yes.
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
Exactly. Always say please, thank you, you're welcome, and excuse me. Sit up straight, hold doors open, don't speak with your mouth full, keep your elbows off the table. Share your things, play nice, and generally treat others the way you'd like to be treated. Got it?
Got it.
And stop picking your nose.
Most parenting is hard to do in just 2 minutes. But 2 minutes twice a day, making sure they brush their teeth, is easier. And it could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain. Visit 2min2x.org to find out more. A message from the Partnership for Healthy Mouths, Healthy Lives, and the Ag Council.
There's always a moment of truth where it's either put up or shut up. We were yelling our hearts out. Even in our weakness, even in our pain, we continued to push. I don't know where the pain went to, but all I know is that I had what it took. I am a United States Marine.
PFC Darrell Willis serves his country as a Marine. Will you? Visit Marines.com or call 1-800-MARINES.
Q30 Television is Quinnipiac's only student.
This is Aaron Robinson. You're listening to Quinnipiac Basketball on WQAQ 98.1 FM. QBSN, the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sport Network.
Tyrese Williams will shoot two from the line. We welcome you back to this presentation of Quinnipiac basketball. And that one rolls in. Brian Schwartz and Kevin Higgins with you.
What I'm interested in right now, Brian, is seeing Tyree Pickron get some minutes for Baker Dunleavy. He only averages about 9 minutes a game.
Pickron is in now. He played a lot against St. Peter's in Quinnipiac's win Friday night. So he'll get some early action here. The Bobcats need depth. And Pickron can bring that to them. He'll play a big role next year.
Yeah, it was interesting watching how the freshmen have developed this year. And Pickron obviously coming into his own recently.
Stewart hits a three. And Young will inbound it all the way up to Atson. A lot of pressure from Manhattan. Obviously, their game plan today was to try to deny Quinnipiac from getting up the court. And there, Cam Young speeds his way inside and gets hacked. 17-13, the Bobcats lead it. With the win, Quinnipiac secures the number two seed in the MAC tournament, which means the game Friday in Albany. Tyrese Williams with the ball. Screen left from Cam Young. Usillo on Williams. Now Young at the top of the key. Manhattan still in their zone. Williams takes a three. That one's no good. And Cam Young gets the rebound. Falls to the ground. The ball goes loose. And it'll go to Manhattan off of Tyrese Williams. Cam Young slow to get up. He looks to be okay. Jacob Rigoni will check back in for the Bobcats.
I think this is the pace Manhattan wants to play at right now. As I've obviously harped on a few times, they're a little slower offensively, and I think right now it's a bit more of a bruising game than a finesse game, and I think that's exactly what Coach Masiello wants for his team.
10:30 to go in the first half. Buchanan, top of the key, finds Usillo. Usillo drives in on Rigoni, gets the help from Bundu, misses the layup, but Abube is right there to get the offensive rebound and put it back up and in for the layup.
Rigoni did a great job defensively there. Actually ended up getting a piece of that shot, but Abube, a force to be reckoned with on the inside.
Manhattan is almost playing like it's like 30 seconds in the game, and you really need to deny the ball in the backcourt. You wonder if that's going to fatigue them later in the game. But for now, haven't gotten a turnover yet from it, but it is working. Finding Rigoni in the paint. Back out for Pickron, Williams, and Young. Bobcats moving the ball around. A screen right from Bundu. Young with six on the shot clock. Young will have to do it himself. Instead, finds Williams. Pickron in the corner. A three. That's good. With the shot clock expiring, Tyree Pickron.
I'll say this. I still think that is the possession Manhattan wanted defensively. I know it might wear them out later in the game, but Quinnipiac was uncomfortable that entire possession. And let's be honest, that was a fortunate three by Pickron there.
A block by Bundu on the Stewart layup. And the ball goes out of bounds. Quinnipiac will get the ball. So after a nice offensive possession for Quinnipiac, getting the three, they come back, and Bundu doing what he does best, denying the ball in the basket.
Bundu, obviously early here on his special day, filling up the box score as he so often does, already with a steal, a block, and 4 points.
Cam Young checks out. So Tyrese Williams with the ball, finding Rich Kelly, who just came back into the game. Williams.
This is a pretty small lineup for Quinnipiac out here as Rigoni kicks that one off his leg, so it'll go to Manhattan. But I'm interested to see how Manhattan will attack offensively against only Bundu is really the big guy for Quinnipiac right there. The rest of them are just smaller guys for the most part.
Baker Dunleavy seems comfortable with that lineup because he does use it a lot with 3 yards. Rigoni, and then either Bundu or Marfo. Manhattan with the ball, top of the key. Nehemiah Mack back into the game. Started by Kelly, a screen left from Abube. Buchanan gets a three. That was no good, and Bundu secures the rebound. A nice box out.
That can't be how the Jaspers attack this lineup. I think Williams needs, I don't even think he's on the court right now. He's not. I think he needs to come back in this game and become presence defensively.
Rich Kelly.
Offensively, rather.
Back out for Williams, Rigoni, and Pickron. He drives in, and he's fouled on the reach-in by Takai Green.
Sometimes it's crazy to see what it can do to a player when he sees the ball go into the basket. The first few minutes Pickron was out there, he seemed a little hesitant on the offensive end, not really knowing what to do. He was just kind of there. Now he's making plays, looks confident with the ball, driving inside there, drew a foul.
8:32 to go in the first half. Quinnipiac up 20-15. Tyrese Williams will inbound from underneath the basket. Finds Kelly in the corner. Kelly gets a pick from Bundu. Pickron, pump fake, left wing, back out for Kelly. Another pump fake, drives inside, now back out for Pickron. Another pump fake. The shot too strong, and Mack will come up with the rebound. Manhattan comes back the other way. Quinnipiac gets set back on defense. Mack drives inside, left-handed dribble. The ball goes loose and out of bounds, but it will stay with Manhattan.
Manhattan there, they allowed the three to pick on what I thought was a good defensive possession from their standpoint, but that time I didn't think they were great defensively. They're biting on everything, and Picron just missed an open shot. This Quinnipiac team, all of them are good shooters, so they're susceptible to the pump fake on the defensive end, but he can't bite at everything.
Buchanan inbounds to Reynolds, who just checked back in. And Mack will slow things down. 15 on the shot clock. Calls out a play. And finds Reynolds. Reynolds guarded by Picron. Into the corner. Usillo. A pump fake on Ragone. Puts it up. And Bundu with the block. And the ball will go back to Quinnipiac as it goes off of Usillo.
That was authoritative by Abdullah Bundu.
A great job by Abdullah Bundu. His second block of the game. And we'll take another timeout. On the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network. Thank you for tuning in today. Q30 TV, Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network, and WQAQ 98.1 FM. We'll be right back.
There are those who dedicate themselves to a sense of honor, to a life of courage, and a commitment to something greater than themselves. They have always defended this nation and each other. They still do. The few. The proud. The Marines.
Okay, what are you wearing right now?
Nothing.
That's right. So mommy's gonna teach you how to dress yourself. Underwear always comes first, name tag at the back, then pants, then shirt. Get the first button in the right hole or you have to start all over. Socks go in first, then shoes, right on right, left on left. With shoelaces, just take the ends, cross them over, switch the loops, the rabbit goes down the hole, pull tight, and you're left with bunny ears. Got it? Why are your pants on your head?
Most parenting is hard to do in just 2 minutes. But 2 minutes twice a day, making sure they brush their teeth, is easier, and it could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain. Visit 2min2x.org to find out more. A message from the Partnership for Healthy Mouths, Healthy Lives, and the Ag Council.
Every day, the men and women of the United States Marine Corps demonstrate their commitment to defend the American way of life. Since 1775, wherever the mission takes us, we always remember the land we call home. As Marines, we take a stand for our nation, for us all. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Hey, it's Emma Spagnolo, General Manager of
You're listening to Quinnipiac Athletics on 98.1 WQAQ and the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network.
Bobcats basketball on QBSN, WQAQ, and Q30 Television. Thank you, everyone, back in the studio for doing what they do today. Quinnipiac with the ball. Cam Young will inbound from underneath the Manhattan basket and inbounds to Rich Kelly. 7:45 to go in the first half. It's 20-15 Quinnipiac. Kelly with Buchanan tightly guarding him. Manhattan still in their zone. Ragone gets the ball, double teamed, finds Young, left wing, now Williams. Williams with a screen right from Bundu, moves inside, back out for Young. A long three, no good, off the back of the rim, and Buchanan will get the rebound.
I think a lot of guys, you say, maybe don't take that shot, a contested deep three, but Cam Young has the green light from anywhere, and he almost got that one to fall.
He did a couple weeks ago at Siena when he had 55 points, the most in Division I this season.
Over the past 10 seasons.
Third most in the past 20. Pretty outstanding feat by Young. Manhattan with the ball. Buchanan drives inside and gets the layup to fall. Moves around Cameron Young. And Elijah Buchanan has a nice field goal there. Rich Kelly and Tyrese Williams. Now Cam Young speeds his way inside. Finds Rich Kelly on the outside. A three. That's good. Kelly with the pump. And the Bobcats lead it by six.
If at first you don't succeed, Rich Kelly 0 for 3 on his first three-pointers and then went on that one. Keep shooting and eventually went in for him.
Nehemiah Mack with the ball. Finds Buchanan. He'll take a three of his own. That one's too strong, and Young will get the rebound.
I like Buchanan's confidence, though. On a team that desperately needs guys to step up and score, Buchanan might be able to do that today with the way he's playing.
Rich Kelly with the ball. Screen left from Bundu. Moves inside. Back out for Williams. Ragone, pump fake. And Williams again. Cam Young, left wing. Here's Rich Kelly again. Bobcats moving the ball around well. Young pumps a shot and gets fouled by Buchanan.
Young obviously upset that he couldn't get a shot off there for a shooting foul. But what I've seen early from Manhattan throughout the first 15 minutes or so is an intense aggressiveness defensively. They've shown it in the full court press. They've shown it in their willingness to stop the ball. And sometimes it results in biting on pump fakes like that. But I think overall it's a good strategy to be that aggressive.
Inbound goes to Kelly, and now it's Tyrese Williams. Finds Rigoni, left elbow. That shot is no good. Bundu tries to get the rebound, and Thomas Capuano dives into the Manhattan bench. Gets it, but it still goes out of bounds. And Quinnipiac will retain possession.
I think with Capuano in right now, Quinnipiac needs to work Young more towards the top of the key and whatever wing Capuano is on. Even though it's a zone, they'll probably be able to exploit him defensively in that matchup.
Inbound for Young goes all the way down the other end to Rigoni. It was a football pass there from Cam Young.
I was going to say, I thought I saw him at the combine yesterday.
Could probably run a pretty fast 40 time.
Probably.
Here's Rich Kelly. Loses his dribble. Finds Rigoni inside. Rigoni trying to get it into Bundu, but Warren Williams is right there. He just checked back into the game. Reynolds finds Williams inside the dunk for Manhattan.
With authority. He put that one down with two hands, and he's amped up right now.
It's a big momentum shifter for Manhattan. They're now down by just four with 5 minutes to go in the first half. Here's Tyrese Williams, top of the key. Kelly drives inside on the baseline. Inside to Bundu. Gets the layup, but his foot was out of bounds. So it'll go to Manhattan and the ball.
Any big man knows that footwork and positioning is the key to their offensive play, and Bundu just an inch away there from a layup, but just had, it looked like the heel of his foot, out of bounds.
It's a four-point lead for Quinnipiac, 4:56 to go in the first half. Samir Stewart takes the ball up for Manhattan. Finding Capuano on the right wing. It's guarded by Kelly. Gets it to Takai Green, and now Stewart will slow things down again. 12 on the shot clock. Screen left. Capuano on the right wing. Capuano drives inside, and a foul on Tyrese Williams.
Well, they actually called an offensive foul on Capuano, and that's going to get called every time. What he did was he drove in. Everyone tries to create space. We see it at the college level. We see it at the NBA level. We see it at the CYO level. But when you extend that arm, they're going to call that every single time.
So the Bobcats get the ball, and Rich Kelly will take it up for Quinnipiac. Cam Young. Now Rich Kelly drives inside, left-handed dribble. Back out for Rigoni, finds Young. An open three at the top of the key, and it rolls out. Off the rim, off the backboard, and out. And Manhattan comes back. Manhattan down by four. Stewart. Gets set. Capuano going inside to Williams, who loses control. Fast break for Quinnipiac. Rich Kelly coming up the other way, and a layup for the Bobcats point guard, and that extends Quinnipiac's lead to six.
We talked before the game about Tyrese Williams defensively, and I used the term human blanket because that is what he can be sometimes. Great hands there. And Kelly with, some people forget how tough of a finish it is when somebody's breathing down your neck like that. So good to finish the bunny there.
Hinkson guarded by Young, backing down. Low block. Hinkson back out. A three ball for Manhattan is no good, and Rich Kelly tries to save it. Gets it to Tyrese Williams, who saves it himself, and Quinnipiac has the ball.
Flashy, flashy behind the back save there by Rich Kelly.
Rigoni near the free throw line. Drives inside, puts up a left-handed layup, no good, and Williams will come up with the rebound.
If you're Jacob Rigoni right now, you have to take a deep breath. Left-handed layups in traffic are not your strong suit, and I think right now he's struggling a little bit from the field. So I think he's trying to do too much.
And we talked about that a little bit before, as Rigoni has been inconsistent. A three from Takai Green for Manhattan. Rigoni has been inconsistent this year. And some games he'll shoot lights out from beyond the arc, and some games he can't buy a bucket from behind the arc.
Certainly one of the X factors is one of the streakier scorers on this team.
He pumps another one, now drives inside. Back out for Kelly, 14 on the shot clock. Atson in the corner, drives inside. He's double teamed. Not much to do with it. Gets it to Rigoni. 8 on the shot clock. Rigoni takes a jumper. Rolls out. And Takai Green for Manhattan comes up with the rebound. 2:28 to go. Stewart, a three. over Rigoni. That's good. And Manhattan has tied it up 25-25 with 2:24 to go in the first half. We'll take a timeout. You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network.
Come, United States Marines. Come from our hometowns to become a part of something greater than themselves. This commitment represents the highest level of steadfast allegiance to the betterment of our communities, our country, and our Marine Corps. The journey will be one of the most challenging, but also one of the most rewarding. The few, the proud, the Marines.
So you see, son, good manners are important. Should I go through it again?
Yes.
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
Exactly. Always say please, thank you, you're welcome, and excuse me. Sit up straight, hold doors open, not speak with your mouth full, keep your elbows off the table. Share your things, play nice, and generally treat others the way you'd like to be treated. Got it?
Got it.
And stop picking your nose.
Most parenting is hard to do in just 2 minutes. But 2 minutes twice a day, making sure they brush their teeth, is easier. And it could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain. Visit 2min2x.org to find out more. A message from the Partnership for Healthy Mouths, Healthy Lives, and the Ag Council.
There's always a moment of truth where it's either put up or shut up. We were yelling our hearts out. Even in our weakness, even in our pain, we continued to push. I don't know where the pain went to, but all I know is that I had what it took. I am a United States Marine.
PFC Darrell Willis serves his country as a Marine. Will you? Visit Marines.com or call 1-800-MARINES.
Q30 Television is Quinnipiac's only student-run television station. Members are able to film, write, produce, and represent Q30.
This is Abdullah Rundu. You're listening to Quinnipiac Bobcat Basketball on WQAQ 98.1 FM QDSN. Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network.
We have a tie ball game here in Hamden. Quinnipiac and Manhattan knotted up at 25. Switch for Quinnipiac. Abdullah Bundu checks back in. So on the floor for Quinnipiac, it's Kelly Young, Williams, Atson, and Bundu. And Rich Kelly will take the ball up. 2:16 to go in the first half. Back and forth this one goes. Young around the screen. Double team now. Gets it inside to Bundu. Left block. Drives in. Puts up a layup. That one's no good. And the rebound goes to Manhattan's Sakai Green.
That's really one of the first poor shots we've seen out of Abdullah Bundu today. He was feeling it early. I think he has 6 points at this point. Just couldn't get that one to go. Heavily contested.
Abube back in the game for Manhattan. And Samson Usillo as well. Buchanan drives inside. Puts up the layup. That one's good. A nice layup there by Buchanan.
That's a tough shot. Tyrese Williams played really good defense there, but Buchanan just drove right in, finished over him. It was perfect defense. Again, no foul or anything. Just a really tough shot there by Buchanan.
Manhattan now takes the lead, 27-25. Their first lead of the game. Rich Kelly with the ball. Drives in. Back out for Atson. Top of the key. Now Young. 9 on the shot clock. Over a minute to go. Young, pump fix. Drives inside. Stops his dribble. Kicks it to the corner. Tyrese Williams a 3. Too strong, and a rebound goes to Takai Green. So Manhattan with a couple stops and a couple scores, and all of a sudden the tides have turned. As the Jaspers start to take control. Inside Takai Green, guarded by Cam Young. Puts up the layup, and it goes as Young hits the deck. No foul called, and Manhattan has a 4-point lead.
Boy, a 10-0 run here very quickly, and now Masiello is going to have them back off a little bit besides pressure on the ball.
Cam Young will slow things down. 20 on the shot clock, 37 left to go in the half. Rich Kelly drives inside, puts up a layup, it's good! And the foul, the shot will not count. But Rich Kelly...
It's a shame that doesn't count. We would have seen that on the highlight reels tomorrow. And in the NBA, that shot counts, but the continuation rule is different in college. That was a circus shot there with the left hand.
So instead it'll be a 1-1 for Kelly. 33 and a half seconds to go in the first half. Manhattan up 29-25. Kelly makes the first, so we'll get a second attempt. 8 points for Rich today. 2 rebounds, 2 assists. He'll get a second from the free throw line. It's the lead for Manhattan. Now just 3. Tyler Reynolds gets ready to check in for Manhattan. Kelly misses the second, and the rebound goes to Abube. So Nehemiah Mack also back in for the Jaspers.
They'll basically get the last shot here because in the first half, the clock continues to run. There's only a two-second differential with about 15 seconds left here. So just take it easy if you're Mack and wait till there's about 10 seconds left.
Mack finds Green. He takes a jumper on the baseline. No good. Bundu with the rebound. 7 seconds to go. Quinnipiac has a shot at one more. Cam Young drives inside. Puts up a three. No good. Too short on the rim. And that'll take us to the half. Quinnipiac down 29-26. An eventful first half, Kevin. It was Quinnipiac early on, and now Manhattan has really taken control.
And I think the key for Manhattan has been shutting down Cam Young. He only has 6 points. Half of them are at the line. Even at the end there, he had a good look for three to tie the game. Couldn't get it.
We'll take a quick break, and we'll come right back. Talk about this game a little bit, and then we'll send it back to the studio with MJ Baird. But first, we'll be right back on the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network.
Everybody in the car, let's go.
What are we gonna do first when we get there, Mom? Go for a hike?
Sure.
What about canoeing? Can we go canoeing too?
I don't see why.
How long does it take to get to the forest?
It's not that far, sweetie.
Are we there yet?
Yep, we're here.
Already?
It's a short drive from your neighborhood to your naturehood. Visit discovertheforest.org to find a neighborhood park or green space near you. Brought to you by the Ad Council and the U.S. Forest Service.
Introducing a new day of the week. It's called Someday. Now, everything you were going to do someday is on the calendar. Want to retire someday? You'll really want this. A My Social Security account at socialsecurity.gov. You can estimate your future benefits and manage current benefits online. Millions of people have a My Social Security account. Get yours today, because someday is here at socialsecurity.gov.
This is boot camp. This is the real thing now. You've never done anything so hard in your life. You don't understand how you can finish. It takes inner strength and desire to become a Marine. When I finished, I was like, I did it. The moment I will never forget is when this drill instructor that I admire so much comes up to me and said, good morning, Marine.
PFC Summer Volkman became a Marine. Can you? Visit Marines.com or call 1-800-MARINES.
Dad, this is fun. I didn't think I'd like kayaking.
Well, I'm glad you enjoyed it, but I think it's time to head back in.
Okay. Can we come back?
Sure. Hey, be careful getting out of the boat.
It's a kayak, Dad.
I'm going to return the kayak.
Can we walk home?
How about a taxi?
It's a short fare from your neighborhood to your naturehood. Visit discovertheforest.org to find a neighborhood park or green space near you. Brought to you by the Ad Council and the U.S. Forest Service.
You're listening to Quinnipiac Athletics on 98.1 WQAQ and the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network.
Hello there, this is Nat King Cole, wishing you all a happy and a Merry Christmas.
The joy of living is in the giving. So let's give lots of toys for tots.
Since 1947, the United States Marine Corps has been helping Santa fill his sleigh, making happier holidays for deserving children right in your community. Go to toysfortots.org and learn how you can make a difference.
Not on my watch, our military service members say, as they volunteer to serve. Not on my watch, they say, as they leave their families behind to keep the rest of ours safe. As they move out, stand firm, and take fire. So not on...
Welcome to the Halftime Show on Q30 Television, the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network, and WQAQ Radio.
To Manhattan for Here Comes the Fun Work, Stick-to-itiveness. They were really struggling offensively early on in this half, especially from range. And then later on, I think eventually they just wore Quinnipiac out, got better shots, and sometimes shots aren't falling. And late in the half, they finally started falling for Manhattan.
Yeah, they did. And Manhattan really turned it on later in the game. Quinnipiac struggled from beyond the arc. We know Cam Young hit that big three that was all the way from Los Angeles. But, you know, that is their strong suit, and they did not do it very well in the first half.
Yeah, you talked about that three. Yeah, that'll be on the highlight reel. That'll be on the hype tape for next year's team. But he only has 6 points right now. And Cam Young having 6 points at halftime never means Quinnipiac is winning. They rely on him for so much of the scoring, and when he's struggling the way he does, they're very unlikely to come out on top.
What do you think Baby WB is telling this team in the locker room right now?
I think they just have to relax. Right now, it seems like Manhattan's intensity defensively has kind of ruffled their feathers a little bit. It seems like they're playing not necessarily scared, but a little more conservatively. And I think they have to put the ball inside more, especially we talked about before the game, but when they're not shooting threes well, they have to get the ball down low to Bundu, who's been efficient, and Marfo, who's almost been non-existent really this half.
Kevin Marfo has not played a lot at all. I wonder why. You know, he is a big force on this team, and he's the guy that's going to really have to make a difference in the MAC tournament if Quinnipiac wants to move on.
Yes, and even defensively as well. Warren Williams is just eating people alive down there, and Elijah Buchanan's looked very strong and powerful on his drive, so I think adding Marfo in there would be a great boost both offensively and defensively.
We'll be back in a few minutes for second half action on the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network, but for now, we'll toss it back to you in the studio.
Guys, thank you. Yep, end of the first half from Hampden. You heard it there. 29-26, Manhattan leads this one. Let's take a quick look at the box score, bring us some live stats. So Manhattan's 29 points. Their leader, Samir Stewart, with 6. Tyreek Green has 5 points. For Quinnipiac, Rich Kelly with 8 points. Cam Young has 6. Abdulai Bundu with 4. Bundu also 2 blocks and 2 steals so far. Kevin Marfo, the only Bobcat with more than one foul, he has 2. So far, no foul trouble on either side. So we bring in our beat reporter, Josh Silverman, who is live at Lender Court. Bring us our halftime update. Josh, first question for you. First impressions. What's going on?
No, MJ, here are my first impressions so far. First of all, Quinnipiac came out firing, especially senior Abdulai Bundu, playing hard, diving for rebounds, diving for steals, looking like he wanted. He scored the first 4 points of the game. Then after that, it kind of was a little bit back and forth, Manhattan zone. You know, it forced Quinnipiac to kind of get out of their rhythm. They weren't really connecting on their shots from behind the arc. And so, you know, Manhattan just was able to force Quinnipiac into bad situations. And then down low, Manhattan was able to really, in the last couple of minutes, able to force Quinnipiac, you know, not into what they wanted to do. Manhattan was able to get some buckets, and they ended on a nice run.
Now, Josh, obviously it's senior day. These 4 Bobcats were honored before the game. So tell me, what have their contributions been to this game so far?
Well, you know, for the seniors, it is surprising. Cam Young has hit a shot that seemed like it was from the parking lot or main campus, whatever you want to call it. I mean, it was deep, but he only has held to 6 points. Abdulai Bundu has a couple points, and, you know, he's added things like rebounds and steals, and, you know, the whole team is playing together. Aaron Robinson started the game but has not seen action since. Obviously, Andrew Robinson was still out with an injury, so we're not sure, you know, we're not going to see him today. And when you look at Cam and Abdulai Bundu, you're not getting the production that Quinnipiac needs if they're going to win this game today.
And Josh, obviously Manhattan up 3 at this point, but Quinnipiac was leading for a majority of the half. Manhattan goes on a 12-2 run towards the latter half of that second half here. So my question is this, what is each team doing well right now?
Well, like I said, Manhattan is playing a zone, and they're forcing Quinnipiac into bad situations. The first thing they're doing is whenever Cam Young gets the ball, they're sliding an extra defender over to him, not letting him take shots over defenders and not letting him really shoot from behind the arc. They're really doing a great job of preventing him from driving to the basket. So just the defense on Cam Young, if you're able to take away Cam Young, Rich Kelly's been, you know, has a couple of baskets but not many, and then Quinnipiac's bench is unable to provide points like they've been unable to throughout the season, and there's very little inside scoring for Quinnipiac. So Manhattan is really controlling the game, or has at least controlled the second half of the first half, and just forcing Quinnipiac into shots that they don't want. And then on the back end, Manhattan isn't taking, you know, very few bad shots. They're really setting up their offense, winding the shot clock down, and converting at the end of it.
All right, Josh, thanks so much for the update, my friend. We'll see you after the game. All right, we're going to take a quick break here on the Q30 Sports Bobcat Game Day halftime show. We'll be right back with more highlights of the first half, as well as out-of-town scores. All right, let's take a look at our out-of-town scores around the MAC today. The Bobcats, not the only team in action. A couple of other games going on around the conference as well. As you see there, you have Fairfield playing St. Peter's. That game, 1 o'clock. Poughkeepsie, and in Poughkeepsie, we have Ryder and Marist. And then Siena and Niagara going on in Niagara Falls. See if we can get you some scores for these games. As for the St. Peter's game, in the top right, the Peacocks lead Fairfield 54-49 in the second half. That game with just a couple minutes remaining in it. We look here at some of the updated scores around the league as well. We have Marist up 35-32 over Ryder. That with just a minute left in the first half. So that first half has a lot of action left in it. And we'll see who will come out at the end of the first half with the lead. And then for the final game, is going to be Siena and Niagara. You see bottom right of your screen. Right now, the Purple Eagles lead by 3, 27-24 at halftime. All right, as we mentioned earlier on in the show, it's the Sports Pause Twitter poll of the week. Will both the men's and women's basketball teams here at Quinnipiac win the MAC tournament? That's your question. You can go online and vote. Twitter.com/Q30Sports. Your answer is pretty simple. You can vote either yes, they'll both win. Only one team will win it. That's either the men or the women. Or if you look at your third option, you have neither of them, which could be a possibility as well. The Bobcats women's team, the first seed going into the playoffs. And as for this men's team, we're watching the game right now. They're fighting for that second spot. And we'll have to see what the outcome of the rest of this game is. As for the MAC standings, we talked about them before the show. Let's have another look at them. Quinnipiac right now, again, this is before today's game against Manhattan. In fact, before any of the games across the league today. Quinnipiac, the 2 seed, 11-6 in conference play, just behind Iona. Canisius, Ryder, and Siena round out the top five. Again, top 5 seeds in the conference will get a bye in the postseason tournament. Monmouth and Marist are 6-7. Manhattan and Niagara, 8-9. And then Fairfield and St. Peter's, 10-11. So Quinnipiac playing that Manhattan team right now that's only fighting for seeding. They are going to play on the Thursday no matter what. However, the question just becomes, where will they fall in the seeding? Let's talk again about some fast facts for this game. Quinnipiac, 4th in the conference with a team free throw percentage of 71%. Manhattan, again, 57%. So 6 of 7 from the line are the Bobcats so far in the game tonight. We have a quick commercial break coming up, and after that, we'll have the first half highlights. Stay with us. All right, so how about some of those first half highlights? We've kept you waiting, so let's check them out. Again, Manhattan leading 29-26 at the end of the first half of action. So from Lender Court, senior day for the Bobcats, as we mentioned. Aaron Robinson maybe wiping some tears away. The senior class, very close. Cam Young, kind of an adopted member of the class as well. So they're playing not only for tonight's game, but for the seniors as well. And there's one there, Abdullahi Bundu, again down low. Two good passes from Rich Kelly to Bundu to get 4 points. He ended the half with four. Cam Young pulls up from downtown, just as Josh Silverman said. That's good for three. But then Manhattan starts to turn things around. Quickly, one more basket from the Bobcats. There, that time, Ty Pickron. Again, down low is Bundu. Again inside, good pass from Kelly. But here comes Manhattan. Remember I mentioned that 12-2 run they went on? Well, here it is. There's a three-pointer from one of the Jaspers there. Again inside, that one over Atson for the basket. And again, different angle now, but Manhattan again inside, working down low. Marfo gets called for a foul on that. As I mentioned, he's only got two fouls in the game, but Manhattan seems to be working it down low. To go back to a little bit of what Josh Silverman talked about, Quinnipiac bench production just not quite where it needs to be for them to be leading in this game. But fortunately for them, they're only losing by 3 points in the half. And Manhattan leading by three, they're trying to work their way up the standings. Quinnipiac trying to cement that second spot at the end of the regular season. All right, let's send it up to the second half of action with our broadcasters, Brian Schwartz and Kevin Higgins. Second half of action is underway. Guys, take it away.
Right where they left off.
You took the words out of my mouth. Ended the first half on a 10-1 run. Already here, Williams effective defensive, or offensively rather. But on the defensive end, I'm still surprised that Kevin Marfo isn't in to potentially negate that.
Well, Bundu is in right now, so at least there is a true forward. And Tyrese Williams steps out of bounds as he drives inside. So Manhattan will get the ball. Another turnover for Quinnipiac.
Yeah, and they didn't have a lot of turnover troubles in the first half. There were a few charges, but it wasn't really an issue. The issue for them was just the typical shots that they take weren't falling. And where this team always can fall into trouble is when the long-range shot isn't falling, what are they going to do? And right now they haven't done much besides keep taking them and try to shoot their way out of it.
Manhattan with the ball, Nehemiah Mack to Reynolds, a three, and he sinks it.
Now, Jacob Rigoni had his hand right in his face. I don't even know how Reynolds saw the basket, but a great shot there as Manhattan seems to be pressing, a bit of a half press on the ball.
Manhattan has their biggest lead of the game. It's 34-26. Cam Young misses a floater, and Manhattan takes it back again. It's Samir Stewart.
Misses is generous. He airballed that. He had no idea what he was doing with the ball until the last possible second, and that's just a panic move. You can't run in with a head full of steam into the trees, basically, and have no idea what you're doing.
Williams misses the layup. Rich Kelly the rebound, and Quinnipiac will take it back the other way. Down by eight. Tyrese Williams to Rich Kelly. Kelly left-handed dribble, puts it behind his back, and now Rigoni will take over. 18 on the shot clock. Williams called for the travel, and nothing is going right for Quinnipiac at the start of this half and since the last couple minutes of the first half.
Well, I think if you're Baker Dunleavy, what you are telling your guys is they have probably played about as poorly as possible to this point. Nothing's falling. They've been sloppy with the ball to an extent, and nothing has worked. They're only down 8 points. There's plenty of time left to turn it around.
34-26, Manhattan leads. Inside to Williams. Warren Williams puts up the layup. No good, and Bundu with the rebound.
But do you see the confidence he played there? He backed down Bundu with just no worries whatsoever, and that one just rimmed out. He's playing with so much confidence right now. I would continue to feed him the ball.
Cam Young cannot get the ball inside. Wanted a foul from Stewart. Kelly feeds inside for Bundu, and he misses the layup. He gets the ball back on the steal, and he's fouled as he attempts another layup, so Bundu will head to the line.
And Bundu's upset, obviously, that he didn't hit that first layup, but a lot of players put their head down and then get back on the defensive end after sulking for a little bit. He went right in and gotten his rebound, and now he at least has a chance to redeem himself here at the line.
Bundu will shoot from the line, his first attempt from the charity stripe today. He's got 4 points. It's the first to make that five. And the interesting thing, Kevin, we've talked about this a lot, and we'll have to find out if there's something wrong with Kevin Marfo. He's played 1 minute today.
Yeah, and he's in his warm-ups right now on the bench. So I didn't notice anything odd in the shoot-arounds or anything like that, but he just hasn't gotten any playing time.
Bundu has played 19 minutes. Marfo just one. Does have two fouls.
That probably has a role in it, but I don't know. At this point, I'm not one to tell any coach how to do their job because they're better at it than I will ever be, but I would probably put him back in at this point.
Right now, he's out. Kelly with the ball. Drives in on Matt. Kelly puts up a floater off the backboard, and now Bundu, the offensive rebound. Pickron in. And that three is no good. Gets his own rebound. And Cam Young, he'll shoot a three. That one's good. And the Bobcats get two offensive rebounds and get 3 points on the board.
That's a killer if you're Manhattan, because that's a three that Quinnipiac really needed, especially out of Cameron Young, their leading scorer. And as you mentioned, they had two chances to put that possession away and were unable to do so.
Ball goes inside. Reynolds gets it tipped off his hand, and the Quinnipiac Bobcats will get the ball back.
And there's Bundu again, full extension to tip that one. It looked like Reynolds was open, but not on Bundu's watch. Tips it off Reynolds' leg and out of bounds.
Samson Usillo and Abube check back in for Manhattan. 16:41 to go in the second half. Manhattan leads it by four. Jacob Rigoni takes the seat for Quinnipiac. And Travis Atson comes back in. The press is back on for Manhattan, and that served them well in the first half.
Especially down the stretch, because early Quinnipiac was playing at their normal pace and efficiency, but down the stretch they really slowed down and really seemed a little tuckered out.
Cam Young, near the free throw line, has Tekai Green on him. Pump fix, drives inside, tries to put up a shot, but Abube stuffs him, and Manhattan comes back the other way. It's Tekai Green, guarded by Kelly. Green puts up a layup, no good, and Usillo on the offensive rebound, tries to tip it back in, can't get it. Tyree Pickrod back up the, with the ball.
I don't know how that tip in by Usillo didn't go in. It seemed like it was halfway down, but it just rolled out.
So Rich Kelly now with the ball. He'll slow things down. Finds Young. Pump fake. Drives inside. Right block. Young with Abube on him. Fades away. Ball rolls out. Bundu tries to tip it away, but Usillo has it, and Bundu almost tackles him into the ground. It'll go to Manhattan, and we have a timeout on the floor. That'll be Bundu's first foul. Timeout on the floor. Manhattan leads Quinnipiac 34-30 with 15:43 to go in the second half. You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network.
Women who become United States Marines come from our hometowns to become a part of something greater than themselves. This commitment represents the highest level of steadfast allegiance to the betterment of our communities, our country, and our Marine Corps. The journey will be one of the most challenging, but also one of the most rewarding. The few, the proud, the Marines.
So you see, son, good manners are important. Should I go through it again?
Yes.
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
Exactly. Always say please, thank you, you're welcome, and excuse me. Sit up straight, hold doors open, don't speak with your mouth full, keep your elbows off the table. Share your things, play nice, and generally treat others the way you'd like to be treated. Got it?
Got it.
And stop picking your nose.
Most parenting is hard to do in just 2 minutes. But 2 minutes twice a day, making sure they brush their teeth, is easier. And it could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain. Visit 2min2x.org to find out more. A message from the Partnership for Healthy Mouths, Healthy Lives, and the Ag Council.
There's always a moment of truth where it's either put up or shut up. We were yelling our hearts out. Even in our weakness, even in our pain, we continued to push. I don't know where the pain went to, but all I know is that I had what it took. I am a United States Marine.
PFC Darrell Willis serves his country as a Marine. Will you? Visit Marines.com or call 1-800-MARINES.
Q30 Television is Quinnipiac's only student-run television station. Members are able to film, write, produce, and represent Q30 as on-air talent. Q30 has three main departments: news, sports, and entertainment. General meetings are the first Sunday of every month in CCE 118. For more information regarding Q30 shows, their president can be contacted at kyle.lavasser@quinnipiac.edu. That's kyle.lavasser@quinnipiac.edu.
You're listening. Back on the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network, Manhattan leads 34-30 over Quinnipiac. Nehemiah Mack with the ball for Manhattan. After the timeout, Tekai Green now into the corner. Green guarded by Kelly. Now top for Mack. And Usillo. A cutting Stewart inside takes the fadeaway jumper. No good. And Kevin Marfo back into the game. Gets the rebound. So it looks like Marfo is totally fine. So maybe the fouls were the reason that he did not play.
Do you think Baker Dunleavy heard us? Do you think?
I don't know. Maybe he's got an earpiece in.
Potentially.
Atson.
I'll take credit for it at the end of the day.
Kelly. Now pick run, pump fake. Double team finds Kelly now. Drives inside. Kelly turns around. Now pick run. A long three. No good. Rebounded by Samson Usillo.
I know that didn't fall, but I love the confidence Ty Pickron is playing with right now.
Takai Green with an open lane. Drives inside. And a foul.
Defensive breakdown there by both Pickron and Atson. Each of them thought that the other was going to stop the ball, and instead it led to them parting like the Red Sea. And Kelly came in and committed the foul late there.
Takai Green will shoot two from the line. Look at that spiral thing, Kevin, behind the backboard that the pep band has.
Well, I wouldn't look at it if I were Takai Green. Maybe he did look at it.
And Takai Green will take his second from the free throw line. That was no good, and Kevin Marfa with the rebound.
It was because of the spiral thing. That was it.
Has to be. So shout out to the Quinnipiac pep band for that. Bobcats with the ball down by four. 14:38 to go in the second half. In the corner. Pickron a three. That one's good.
I'm sorry to cut you off there. He's really kind of feeling himself right now. He has two threes, and when he's hit them both, he's just been immediately pumped up, looking at his own bench, getting the guys pumped up.
Tyree Pickron is a key for Quinnipiac. Definitely lengthens their bench if he's on his game. Freshman. Mack. Outside to Abube. He takes a three over Marfo. That one's too short. Kelly tips it to Atson, and the Bobcats have the ball back.
I didn't know Abube had that type of range, but didn't get that one to go there.
Kelly drives inside, guarded by Mack, puts up a layup, it rolls out, and Marfo tips it. And it'll go to Manhattan as Marfo tipped it out of bounds.
Right now, I'm interested to see how Manhattan attacks Quinnipiac on the offensive end because Warren Williams is out of the game. He needed a bit of a rest. So I'm interested to see how Abube, especially on the interior, attacks them.
Stewart to Buchanan and inside to Usillo, guarded by Atson. Usillo puts up a layup. It's good, and the foul.
Atson can play bigger than that. I don't know why he was crouched so low, but it gave Usillo the opportunity to rise over him for that shot, and he got fouled in the process. Tough shot by Usillo there.
So Manhattan leads it 36-33 now, and Usillo will have a chance to make it a three-point play from the free throw line. Samson Usillo, that was his first bucket of the game. The spiral thing is at it again, but instead, Usillo makes it. Did no damage there.
Not this time.
Cam Young will take it up for Quinnipiac. Young held to just 9 points so far. He's leading Quinnipiac, but he's very unlike Cam Young. You expect 30 points already.
Exactly, and I think Quinnipiac is a little spoiled on that end. His nine is perfectly acceptable at this point, but not up to Cam Young's numbers.
10 on the shot clock. Cam Young to Rich Kelly. Kelly a long three. That one's good. And Rich Kelly has cut the lead to just one.
And that's where Kelly's so dangerous. Just stared in the defender's face and drained it.
Takai Green drives inside. Blocked by Marfo. Manhattan retains it and will get another chance. 20 on the shot clock. Usillo, top of the key. Stewart now takes over. Guarded by Pickron. 14 on the shot clock. Screen left from Usillo. Stewart now goes around a screen from Abube. Now inside to Abube. Puts up a left-handed layup. That one's good over Marfo. And Manhattan extends its lead to three.
And Travis Atson over-rotated on that screen there. We're supposed to help Marfo down low, but because of the screen, he was too far away and couldn't get there in time.
Young up to Pickron. And back for Young. Manhattan playing with a light press there. Young drives inside, and he's fouls.
And Cam Young, as great as he is, sometimes when it's a physical game and if he's getting fouled on a consistent basis, it can throw him off a little bit. So even though you're committing a foul on him, as long as it's not a shooting foul and as long as it's not committed by a player in foul trouble, I think it could be positive on Manhattan's end to kind of rattle him a little bit with excessively physical play.
Cam Young will inbound from right in front of the Bobcats bench, finds Tyrese Williams. A very small lineup out on the floor for Quinnipiac right now. Cam Young's probably playing the four at this point. with Atson, Picron, and Williams alongside Marfo. Atson drives in. Nice pass to Marfo. He's stripped, but a foul.
This is what Quinnipiac needs more of. They go to the line more than any other team in the MAC, and they have to feed the ball inside. Kevin Marfo looked extremely confident there in picking that one off the pass and just going straight up with it. So I think they need more of that going forward.
Marfo will shoot two from the free throw line. And on the first, he sinks it. In for Manhattan, Warren Williams back in. Marfo's and Nehemiah Mack.
I'm sorry to cut you off. Marfo's put a lot of work into his free throws. Whenever we've seen him at practice, he's always there at the line and has developed into a 61% shooter as he hits the second there.
Goes two for two from the free throw line there. 39-38, Manhattan leads. 12 minutes to go in the second half. Mack. Guarded by Williams, slowing things down. 17 on the shot clock. In front of the Manhattan bench. Now goes around the other way to Capuano. Back for Mack. Gets a screen left from Abube. Mack takes a free throw line shot, and that's good.
It's rare to see a zone broken like that right down the middle at the free throw line. So when it is, it's important to take advantage of that opportunity, and Mack did.
Cam Young now. Screen from Marfo. Instead finds Williams. Tyrese Williams slows it down. Right-handed dribble. Guarded by Mack. Marfo at top of the key. A little bit of a mismatch there. Marfo had Capuano on him. Now Cam Young will take over. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Young, a pump fake. Young will give it to Picron. A long three. That's no good. And Takai Green gets the rebound.
That's not efficient enough. Picron's played well today, but that's out of just about anyone's range.
Capuano to Mack. And Manhattan will now really slow things down. Rich Kelly gets ready to come back into the game. Capuano, left-handed dribble. Bounce pass to Usillo, down low. Blocked by Marfo. Kevin Marfo swats that all the way to the first row of the bench.
He could have blocked that with his chin. He was so high up in the air.
Marfo extended his arms, and that was a big-time block. And we'll take a break. Manhattan leads Quinnipiac 41-38, but Manhattan will have the ball after we come back from this quick timeout. You're listening to Bobcats Basketball on the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network.
Everybody in the car, let's go.
What are we going to do first when we get there, Mom? Go for a hike?
Sure.
What about canoeing? Can we go canoeing too?
I don't see why.
How long does it take to get to the forest?
It's not that far, sweetie.
Are we there yet?
Yep, we're here.
Already?
It's a short drive from your neighborhood to your naturehood. Visit discovertheforest.org to find a neighborhood park or green space near you. Brought to you by the Ad Council and the U.S. Forest Service.
Introducing a new day of the week. It's called Someday. Now, everything you were going to do someday is on the calendar. Want to retire someday? You'll really want this. A My Social Security account at socialsecurity.gov. You can estimate your future benefits and manage current benefits online. Millions of people have a My Social Security account. Get yours today, because someday is here at socialsecurity.gov.
This is boot camp. This is the real thing now. You've never done anything so hard in your life. You don't understand how you can finish. It takes inner strength and desire to become a Marine. When I finished, I was like, I did it. The moment I will never forget is when this drill instructor that I admire so much comes up to me and said, good morning, Marine.
PFC Summer Volkman became a Marine. Can you? Visit Marines.com or call 1-800-MARINES.
Dad, this is fun.
This is Aaron Robinson. You're listening to Quinnipiac Basketball on WQAQ 98.1 FM. QBSN, the Quinnipiac Bobcat Sport Network.
To 38, Manhattan leads Quinnipiac. And Manhattan will have the ball with 7 seconds left on the shot clock. Inbound to Green, guarded by Williams. Finds Usillo, 5 on the shot clock. Usillo, a 3, rims out, and Tyrese Williams comes away with the rebound. Williams, a bounce pass to Atson. Down the low block, Marfo, almost stripped. Marfo goes up with it, and he's fouled.
And that's 2 straight possessions now. Thank where you. They've gotten the ball to Kevin Marfo, and he's immediately drawn contact and been strong inside.
41-38, Manhattan leads. Marfo, who just went 2 for 2 from the free throw line, get another opportunity. Sinks the first.
I'm looking at the stats here. Coming into this game, I thought that if Manhattan wanted a chance to win, they were going to have to compete at the line, get there more often, and they're being outshot at the line anyways. They only have 4 free throw attempts, and Quinnipiac has 13, and that's the reason that Quinnipiac's still in this game, honestly.
10:30 to go. A one-point lead for Manhattan. Nehemiah Mack finds Usillo. Drives inside. And there's a foul out on the floor before the shot. Tyrese Williams.
Usillo's playing with extreme confidence right now, especially when guarded by Atson, as Atson will now get subbed out of the game. But Usillo has really kind of taken control, and on a team where there's no go-to guy, sometimes it's a game-by-game basis, and Usillo looks to be that guy right now.
Samson Usillo, one of the seniors on this Manhattan team. Manhattan with the ball again. It's Nehemiah Mack. He's a sophomore, guarded by the other sophomore, Rich Kelly. Finds Green, drives inside, Young hits the deck, blocked by Marfo, but that'll be called a goaltending as it was coming off the backboard.
Young's looking for an offensive foul there, but I like the no call. I don't think Young flopped by any means, but sometimes when there's contact, basketball's a contact sport, and I think sometimes we lose sight of that, and when anyone's touching anyone, fouls are called, and I like the no call there. And Manhattan continuing the full court press here.
Cam Young will inbound as Manhattan does press. And Quinnipiac will be forced to call a timeout. Good job by Manhattan's defense there, surrounding Quinnipiac.
Defensively, if you're not going to force a turnover on an inbounds play, the next best thing is a timeout to have them waste one here, especially with so much time left in the game.
We'll take a break. Manhattan leads 43-40 on the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network.
Everybody in the car, let's go.
What are we going to do first when we get there, Mom? Go for a hike?
Sure.
What about canoeing? Can we go canoeing, too?
I don't see why.
How long does it take to get to the forest?
It's not that far, sweetie.
Are we there yet?
Yep, we're here.
Already?
It's a short drive from your neighborhood to your naturehood. Visit discovertheforest.org to find a neighborhood park or green space near you. Brought to you by the Ad Council and the U.S. Forest Service.
Introducing a new day of the week. It's called Someday. Now, everything you were going to do someday is on the calendar. Want to retire someday? You'll really want this. A My Social Security account at socialsecurity.gov. You can estimate your future benefits and manage current benefits online. Millions of people have a My Social Security account. Get yours today, because someday is here at socialsecurity.gov.
This is boot camp. This is the real thing now. You've never done anything so hard in your life. You don't understand how you can finish. It takes inner strength and desire to become a Marine. When I finished, I was like, I did it. The moment I will never forget is when this drill instructor that I admire so much comes up to me and said, good morning, Marine.
PFC Summer Volkman became a Marine. Can you? Visit Marines.com or call 1-800-MARINES.
Dad, this is fun. I didn't think I'd like kayaking.
Well, I'm glad you enjoyed it, but I think it's time to head back in.
Okay. Can we come back?
Sure. Hey, be careful getting out of the boat.
It's a kayak, Dad.
I'm going to return the kayak.
Can we walk home?
How about a taxi?
It's a short fare from your neighborhood to your naturehood. Visit discovertheforest.org to find...
10:09 to go. Manhattan leads by 3. Quinnipiac will have another chance to inbound after they couldn't on the last try. They have to take a timeout. A nice crowd here today at the People's United Center. And Quinnipiac easily able to inbound it. No press there from Manhattan. 43-40. Jasper's lead. Rich Kelly to Tyrese Williams. Top of the key, guarded by Mack. Now here's Cam Young. Screen right from Marfo. Young finds Williams. An open three. Tyrese Williams hits on the three. And the Bobcats have tied up the game at 43.
And they need more out of Williams. That's only his fifth point, hopefully, from Quinnipiac's vantage point, a sign of good things to come.
Mack to Green with Kelly on him. Now back to Usillo. Usillo near the free throw line. A three attempt, no good. And it goes off of Green, and Quinnipiac would get the ball back.
And I think if you're Quinnipiac right now, Manhattan, as we've mentioned a few times, only shoots 33% from deep. You're going to live with them taking somewhat open shots in the zone as that one was, just because they're not as efficient from three-point land.
Cam Young dribbles it up, and we'll have to give it to Williams. Tie game, 9-10 to go. Rigoni, Kelly, and now Williams with Matt. Cam Young, 7 on the shot clock. A long three, no good. The rebound goes off of Abube, and the fight for it with Marfo, and Marfo has it, and it'll be called a jump ball. Three Manhattan defenders with Kevin Marfo. It's a jump ball, and it'll stay with Quinnipiac, and a loud ovation for the Bobcats
center.
Yeah,
for those of you listening at home, this crowd just got on its feet for the effort that Kevin Marfo just showed. He is always an intense player on the court, and him and Bundu just have a knack, don't they, for just going down and constantly trying to pick up loose balls.
That's the difference that a guy like Kevin Marfo can make. And Quinnipiac missed that when he only played a minute in the first half. Inbound to Rigoni, now Young. Top of the key. New shot clock guarded by Usillo. Young dribbles through his legs. Stops. Rides in. A layup off the backboard and in. Cam Young gives the Bobcats the lead.
Perfect defense by Usillo. Just nothing you can do against the Max leading scorer.
Cam Young now up to 11 points. Stewart inside to Usillo. Green pumps a three. Now takes it. Too strong. And Cam Young will get the rebound, and he's fouled by Abube.
That's a careless foul right there. Listen, Cam Young has that rebound. Unless there's no way he's not coming down with that rebound, so it's just a needless shove out of bounds and a needless hindrance to your team.
Tyler Reynolds checks back in for Manhattan. Usillo will take a seat.
I'm surprised they sat Usillo down. Sorry to jump over you there. But Usillo seemed to be playing very confidently on the offensive end, so I'm surprised they sat him down, probably just for some rest.
Tyrese Williams with a nice job to get the ball up past the half-court line. And now finds Rich Kelly. Kelly slows things down. Two-point edge for the Bobcats. Rigoni now to Kelly, right wing. Kelly with two defenders on him. Double team. Finds inside Young. Young near the free throw line. Steps back. Jumper, no good. Rebound by Manhattan.
I didn't like that shot from Cam Young, and I don't say that often, but that was just a step back, heavily contested from three as Manhattan turns it over by stepping out of bounds.
Stewart tried to drive in and was too close to the out-of-bounds line underneath the basket, so Quinnipiac will get the ball when we come back from this timeout. You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network. Quinnipiac up by two.
Young men and women who become United States Marines come from our hometowns to become a part of something greater than themselves. This commitment represents the highest level of steadfast allegiance to the betterment of our communities, our country, and our Marine Corps. The journey will be one of the most challenging, but also one of the most rewarding. The few, the proud, the Marines.
So you see, son, good manners are important. Should I go through it again?
Yes.
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
Exactly. Always say please, thank you, you're welcome, and excuse me. Sit up straight, hold doors open, don't speak with your mouth full, keep your elbows off the table. Share your things, play nice, and generally treat others the way you'd like to be treated. Got it?
Got it.
And stop picking your nose.
Most parenting is hard to do in just 2 minutes. But 2 minutes twice a day, making sure they brush their teeth, is easier. And it could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain. Visit 2min2x.org to find out more. A message from the Partnership for Healthy Mouths, Healthy Lives, and the Ag Council.
There's always a moment of truth where it's either put up or shut up. We were yelling our hearts out. Even in our weakness, even in our pain, we continued to push. I don't know where the pain went to, but all I know is that I had what it took. I am a United States Marine.
PFC Darrell Willis serves his country as a Marine. Will you? Visit Marines.com or call 1-800-MARINES.
Q30 Television is Quinnipiac's only student-run television station. Members are able to film, write, produce.
Quinnipiac up 45-43. You're listening to the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network and WQAQ 98.1 FM. And also today on Q30 Television, thank everyone back in the studio. 7:44 to go in the second half. Quinnipiac will have the ball. Rigoni will inbound. On the floor for the Bobcats, it's Rigoni, Marfo, Williams, Kelly, and Cam Young. The inbound goes to Cam Young. Another pressure from Manhattan. Williams speeds his way up. And now top of the key, it's Rich Kelly. Cam Young, double teamed. Back out for Kelly. Driving inside, now kicking it back out to Rigoni. The three is way off the backboard, didn't even touch the rim.
I think it might be time, if you're Baker Dunleavy, to just give Jacob Rigoni a little bit on the bench here.
Or red light from the three. Yeah. Reynolds misses a three, and it's an over-the-back foul.
Some coaches refer to players in a game as conductors or passengers. If you're a conductor, you're in charge, you're confident, you're doing whatever. If you're a passenger, you're kind of just there for the ride, and you're there. Jacob Rigoni's a great player, no doubt, but today he hasn't had that touch, hasn't had that confidence, has been a bit more of a passenger. No points, no assists so far.
Two-point lead without Rigoni's big contributions today still. Williams stops, puts up a floater, no good, and Abube comes away with the rebound. And Nehemiah Mack will take it back up for Manhattan. Hinkson back into the ball game. And Mack again. Here's Hinkson, left wing, Mack. A three ball. That one's no good. Rebounded off of Abube, and Quinnipiac will get the ball.
I have a little secret there. That was not off of Abube. That was off of Rigoni. I think a missed call there.
Yeah, I'm surprised they're not looking to double check that one.
You're probably not going to do a review with 7 minutes left, but I'm surprised that another official didn't catch that.
Nonetheless, Quinnipiac has the ball. Marfo takes a seat, and Bundu checks back in for the Bobcats. Kelly now to Young. Young drives baseline. Euro step, and he's fouled. Nice shot by Cam Young to draw the foul.
Some games you just have to grind it out. Sometimes it's not there for you naturally, as it usually is for Cam Young, and you're just going to have to put your head down, take some contact, draw a foul. And that's what he has had to adapt to, especially in the second half.
So Young will shoot from the free throw line. Makes the first. Cam Young's got 12 today. 4 for 4 from the free throw line. It's a three-point lead now for Quinnipiac. On the second, Young misses. And here comes Manhattan the other way. Mack calls out a play. Finds Stewart. Now it's Green. Stewart, top of the key. Inside to Hinkson, a jumper. Rims out, Williams with the rebound. Tyrese Williams to Cam Young. Young back to Williams. Screen right from Bundu. Williams back out for Young off his fingertips and out of bounds.
Bit of a miscommunication there. It happens. It's a very common miscommunication, but it's magnified a little bit in a one-possession game with under 10 to go.
Green inbounds to Mack. 6 minutes to go. It's a three-point lead for Quinnipiac. Tyree Pickron gets ready to check in. Hinkson pumps, puts up a layup, no good. Williams gets the rebound and puts it back home for a dunk and a foul.
Wow.
That was impressive.
I mean, he went up with a lot of contact. He didn't just lay it in. Two-handed, shaking the rim. My goodness.
That's a freshman right there, Warren Williams, who's had a very good year for Manhattan.
Yeah, he leads the team in scoring and is second in rebounding. And listen, Manhattan's had a rough year. There's no denying that. But this is a very young team. Reminds me a little bit of Quinnipiac last year just in terms of youth. And I think they have a bright future, and he's going to be the cornerstone.
Teams like Manhattan and Siena, both very young. Manhattan, obviously, the free throw rolls in. Steve Masiello's been here a while. Siena's coach, Jamion Christian, it's his first year, and they also have a lot of young players and some transfers. Both of those teams could do some damage, and you never know if next weekend they surprise some teams in the MAC tournament.
If there's one thing we know about the MAC, it's that we know nothing about the MAC.
Exactly.
Anybody can beat anybody on a nightly basis.
Rich Kelly takes a three. That one's good.
That was a deep three from Rich Kelly, and I know that's his range, but just to have the confidence to step up and take that one there.
Bobcats lead it by three. Mack inside. And back out, an open three from Takai Green, an air ball, and Travis Atson is right there to catch the fly ball.
Yeah, that was like fielding practice a little bit there, and I think Quinnipiac, again, will allow Manhattan to take those shots going forward.
Cam Young tries to drive inside, and it's called a jump ball, so Manhattan will get the ball back. Young gets really low when he drives inside.
He really does. In that particular case, I thought he traveled, so that ends up benefiting Quinnipiac, even though they called a jump ball and Manhattan will get the possession. It switches it to Quinnipiac's possession next time. Today especially, it just seems like he hasn't had that vintage power on his inside drives, and he hasn't gotten the looks that he's wanted.
Mack to Reynolds, into the corner. Stewart, a three. Too strong, but Warren Williams gets the rebound, and it's a over-the-back foul. Quinnipiac will get it back.
Manhattan is starting to look like Quinnipiac did late in the first half. Early on in this game, or late in the first half, early in the second half, Manhattan was feeling it from deep. They're not doing that anymore, and I think Coach Masiello has to tell them that and try to push it inside a little more to guys like Williams, to guys like Abube.
4:49 to go in the second half. It's a three-point lead for Quinnipiac. Cam Young will have the one-on-one.
It doesn't really feel like Quinnipiac's winning this game. They've played right into Manhattan's hands as Young hits the first, but this is the game Manhattan wanted Quinnipiac to play for the most part. Ugly, not finesse at all, and they've had to grind out every bucket, it seems like. And it is surprising. If you just look at the play, it's surprising to kind of look up and see that they're ahead on the scoreboard.
It's a four-point lead. Cam Young can make it five right now with the free throw. Makes the second. So 51-46, Quinnipiac leads. Under 5 minutes to play. The defense chant starts up. Quinnipiac students.
Well, there's been nothing but defense all day.
Mack.
Offense chance would help better.
Takes the jumper and misses. Exactly your point. Boudou the rebound, and Kelly comes back the other way. Screen left. Rich Kelly. Another screen right from Boudou. Kelly drives inside. Underneath the basket. He's got some space, and Williams with the block. Manhattan comes back the other way. Mack driving inside, kicking it out to Reynolds. A three, and that's good. Tyler Reynolds has shot the ball well from beyond the arc, and he converts another. It's 51-49, Quinnipiac.
And I did say that maybe they should allow Manhattan to take some threes, but Reynolds is like the one guy on the team that's deadly from there, so he takes advantage.
We'll be right back. Quinnipiac leads it 51-49.
Hello there, this is Nat King Cole, wishing you all a happy and a Merry Christmas.
The joy of living is in the giving. So let's give lots of toys for tots.
Since 1947, the United States Marine Corps has been helping Santa fill his sleigh, making happier holidays for deserving children right in your community. Go to toysfortots.org and learn how you can make a difference.
Not on my watch, our military service members say, as they volunteer to serve. Not on my watch, they say, as they leave their families behind to keep the rest of ours safe. As they move out, stand firm, and take fire. So not on our watch, we say, to the severely ill or injured veterans who can't get the care they deserve. The therapists they need to walk again. The treatment they need to talk again. The lifetime of day-to-day help they need to live full and independent lives. When there's no more government funding, or a nursing home seems like the only option, or everyone says there's no hope for recovery, we won't leave one warrior behind. Not on our watch. Find out how you can do your part at findwwp.org.
Hey, it's Emma Spagnolo, General Manager of WQAQ. Are you looking for a fun and creative way to get the word out about your business while trying to appeal to a young group of college students? Well, look no further. WQAQ is Quinnipiac University's student-run radio station. Here at WQAQ, we allow businesses of all kinds to advertise their products and services to our dedicated listeners. All we ask is that you provide our production team with copy points for your...
This is Abdullah Rundu. You're listening to Quinnipiac Bobcat Basketball on WQAQ 98.1 FM, UBSN. Quinnipiac Bobcat Sports Network.
4:11 to go. Bobcats have the ball, up by two. Here's Rich Kelly, top of the key. Brian Schwartz and Kevin Higgins with you on the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network. Rich Kelly, a long three. That's good.
Almost the same spot where he hit that last one, just a deep three. There's no defense for that.
We talked about how he missed the first couple three-pointers, and now he's really turned it on. Another three attempt from Reynolds, and he sinks it.
I love this type of basketball. Just back-to-back haymakers here. Three straight if you're counting Reynolds' last three.
Anything you can do, can do better.
I got it.
I thought you were going to say that.
I'm sorry.
54-52, Quinnipiac leads. Here's Cam Young. Rich Kelly steps into another jumper. No good. Rebounded over the back by Boundou. So Manhattan will get the ball.
That's the right call. Even Abdullah Boundou giving a thumbs up to the official. Like, okay, you got me on that one.
Travis Atson checks out. Jacob Rigoni back in. 3:15 to go. 2-point lead. The second seed in the MAC tournament is on the line. Cam Young tips that away and out of bounds, and Manhattan will stay with it.
I think Manhattan right now, they've found their guy for the time being in Tyler Reynolds, and I think you just almost have to force the ball to him offensively.
Warren Williams checks back in. Abube Abube takes a seat.
I think this could be the lineup for Manhattan to maybe take back the lead here with both Reynolds and Williams out there with Mack.
Pickron checked in for Quinnipiac. Down low, it's Usillo. Kicks it back out. Mack, an open three. No good. Short, and Usillo gets the offensive rebound. Here's Stewart. He's got an open three. That's no good. Usillo tips it back up and in. He wasn't even trying to put the ball in the basket.
Now, here's the deal. That was an incredible play, obviously, but Usillo then hung on the net before the shot went in, so I thought that could have been called basket interference.
And an eight-second violation, is it?
Yeah, I believe they did call the 10-second violation.
10 seconds.
And Steve Masiello, I'll tell you this, he's like the Energizer Bunny on the sideline. He is just constantly talking, constantly pacing back and forth, engaging with the officials, engaging with the players, and he is pumped up out there.
So Manhattan will get the ball back. It's going to be like had trouble moving the ball up the floor. It's 54 all, 2:34 to go. It's an exciting one. Nehemiah Mack finds Reynolds into the corner. Stewart tries to get it inside to Williams, and it's a reach-in foul on Jacob Rigoni.
That's a tough foul call, in my opinion. I think it's just two guys going for the ball. There's going to be physical contact. Not a fan of that call.
2:25 to go. Warren Williams from the line. It's 1-for-2 today from the free throw line. He's got 9 points. And on the first, Williams misses. So Quinnipiac has the ball now. Here's Rich Kelly taking it up. Stewart playing it really close, but Quinnipiac gets it over the half-court line. Rigoni back to Kelly. Top of the key. Guarded by Stewart. 15 on the shot clock. Kelly takes a three. Way too short. Usillo the rebound. And Manhattan will get it back with a chance to take the lead. 2 minutes left.
I think both teams have to go inside now. Their outside shooting has failed them for the most part today. In crunch time, sometimes you got to get dirty.
Reynolds into the corner. A three ball for Manhattan. It's Nehemiah Mack.
I was joking when I said they should go inside. I meant to say find corner threes.
Mack sinks a three, and Manhattan has a three-point lead. A minute 36 to go. Kelly drives inside, kicks it into the corner. Tyree Pickron a three. No good. Pickron gets his own rebound, drives inside, puts it up, blocked by Williams. A clean block, so Manhattan will have possession. A minute 25 to go.
Great defensive effort by Williams there to play smart defense on a smaller defender that he knew he could dominate without even having to foul.
Both teams have two timeouts left. 15 on the shot clock. Mack slowing things down. Mack with Kelly guarding him. Screen left from Reynolds. Mack drives inside. Reynolds a three. No good. Rebounded by Warren Williams. Williams tries to pass it back out, and the ball goes loose. And instead, Kevin Marfo is called for a foul.
And rebounding extraordinaire, Kevin Marfo went to sleep on that one right there, allowing Williams to get the board.
Foul was on Rich Kelly, not Kevin Marfo. Nonetheless, Warren Williams will shoot from the line after this timeout. Baker Dunleavy calls for a timeout. A three-point lead for Manhattan, Kevin. Under a minute to go, 58.9 seconds left. It's been a good one.
It has, and it's kind of picked up a bit as of late. It's been obviously tight the whole game long. I don't know if either team has ever been up by double digits, but Manhattan has taken a lot of threes, and they had missed a lot, but Nehemiah Mack finally got one to go to give them the lead here. If you're Quinnipiac, though, this is still a good situation for you. It's a 1-1 at the line. Williams, who's a poor free throw shooter, is up there. He's probably going to miss one of the two. And obviously Quinnipiac's hoping it's the first one. But even if he doesn't, Quinnipiac has plenty of time with 58 seconds left to go down. And I think they just have to – I know they'd be down by multiple possessions, but I think they have to feed it inside just to get some points on the board.
And the guy you got to look at is Cam Young. He's only got 14 points today in 37 minutes. He's practically played the entire game. But that's not like Cam Young for just 14 points.
He's truly been neutralized both on the outside and inside part of his games.
Warren Williams from the free throw line. He's 1-for-3 today. The 1-1 with 58.9 seconds to go. Manhattan a three-point lead. Williams sinks the first. He'll get a second.
He has no spin on his free throw, and that's nerve-wracking as a coach or as a teammate or as a fan to watch that and know if it hits the rim, it's probably going to miss.
Williams will get a second. It's now a four-point lead for Manhattan. Williams could pad the lead a little bit more with another free throw, and he makes it. Two big free throws for Warren Williams. And Tyler Reynolds will check out. Tekai Green comes back in.
Looks like Masiello's going to employ a semi-press here defensively to take time off the clock.
So Cam Young will bring it back up. Screen left from Marfo. Young drives inside, misses the layup. Marfo, the offensive rebound, backing Williams down and gets the layup to fall.
That is such a tough shot from Marfo there. Had to back down a tough defender in Williams to get that one to go.
Quinnipiac down by three. They need a stop. 40 seconds to go, and Rich Kelly is called for the reach-in foul.
They didn't need that foul there. You didn't have to be so aggressive if you're Quinnipiac there. There's a 14-second differential, and now Manhattan's going to head back to the line.
So Kelly called for the foul. It's Kelly's third personal. It's a three-point lead for Manhattan, 59 to 56. 39.3 seconds left on the clock.
Quinnipiac is one of those teams that seems to just be frantic offensively in the last minute, and we've seen them almost complete many different comebacks while trailing with under a minute to go.
Mack makes the first free throw. Now a four-point lead for Manhattan. Quinnipiac does have one timeout left. Manhattan with two. Here's Mack, his second attempt. And that's good. 61 to 56, Manhattan leads.
You wouldn't be able to guess this if basically 50% free throw shooting team. They've gone four for their last four in crunch time.
Cam Young with the ball, 32 seconds to go. Young drives inside, puts up a layup, no good, but the foul is called. Believe it'll be on Warren Williams, and Cam Young will head to the free throw line.
I thought Williams had good position there, but the officials thought otherwise, and Young really has to hit both of these.
So Cam Young will shoot from the free throw line. Young is 6 of 7 today from the charity stripe. Steve Masiello calls a quick timeout.
So I think if you're Quinnipiac here, it's obviously a little early for the intentional miss. I think you're banking on Young making both free throws, obviously, and then it's just going to be the foul game. You hope that eventually Manhattan cracks under the pressure and that he can take advantage on the other end. And it's 28.8 seconds left. It's going to be a long time with the amount of stoppages we're going to have. And if you're Quinnipiac, you're hoping that eventually Manhattan wears down and misses one, two, maybe three free throws down the stretch to give them a pulse.
Cam Young from the free throw line, as I just said, he's 6 of 7 from there today. Tyler Reynolds checks back in for Manhattan. Aaron Robinson is back into the game for Quinnipiac. We haven't seen him since early on. Young hits his first.
And, I mean, Robinson's in for one reason and one reason only, and that's to shoot threes. They need them down a few possessions here late.
Quinnipiac down by four, 28.8 seconds to go. Young hits the second free throw. It's now a three-point game, 61-58. Usillo passes it into Mack. He's trapped in the corner. Mack finds Reynolds right in front of us. Marfo's on top of him. Reynolds finds it all the way down to Tekai Green. And now Manhattan will get fouled. It's Usillo, who was fouled by Young with 19 seconds to go. And Usillo will head to the free throw line. He almost traveled.
That was a great, regardless of whether or not that was a travel, that was a great job breaking the press by Manhattan. We had Kevin Marfo right in front of us, and I'll be honest with you, Brian, it was downright terrifying. I don't know what it was like for Tyler Reynolds to have that man in his face, but he still found a way to clear his head, open up a little bit, and get a pass down the court.
19 seconds to go. Samson Usillo will shoot from the free throw line. Usillo on the first. He misses. A big miss.
That was woefully short on that one.
Abube checks back in for Manhattan. And for Quinnipiac, Tyree Picron will come in for Marfo. Jacob Rigoni will come in for Robinson. So on the floor for Quinnipiac, it's Rigoni, Picron, Kelly, Williams, and Marfo. Excuse me, not Marfo, Young. And that rolls out. 0-for-2 from the free throw line. Quinnipiac with a chance to tie it up. Shot clock turns off. 14 seconds to go. Cam Young in the corner. It's knocked away. Tekai Green hits it out of bounds. And Quinnipiac will retain possession right in front of us. And a timeout called by Baker Dunleavy. Kevin, how about this?
This is why we love broadcasting. One possession game. Under 10 seconds left. Chance to tie it up. A plethora of options offensively from Quinnipiac. Obviously, they'll be looking for Cam Young to try take and make this shot in crunch time. But you have Kelly, you have Rigoni, who has been off today, but he can still hit it anytime, anywhere. And the emergence of Tyree Picron from 3-day leaves you with about three or four options to potentially try to tie this game up.
61-58, Manhattan leads Quinnipiac. We'll stay with you right here. And as a timeout from Baker Dunleavy.
I think what should be lauded here is Manhattan's durability throughout this game. There are points in the second half where it seemed like they were one or two possessions away from maybe being opened up and maybe Quinnipiac not necessarily running away with it, but taking a substantial enough lead. And it always seemed like whenever Manhattan needed that stop, they got that stop. Or if they needed that bucket, they got that bucket. And that's why they are where they are right now.
It's 61-58. Out of timeout. The fans are on their feet now. A loud crowd today on senior day for Quinnipiac. They want to go out with a bang.
And Baker Dunleavy has five shooters on the floor. It's Young, it's Williams, it's Rigoni, it's Kelly, and it's Picron. All five of which can light it up from deep.
Cam Young will inbound right in front of us. Young with Tekai Green right in front of him and a timeout for Steve Masiello. It's a chess game right now.
It really is, right? Masiello obviously has been doing this for a long time. Always a smart move to see how your opponent's going to line up and then call timeout to adjust accordingly.
So Quinnipiac is down by three, 10.8 seconds to go. And you can't ask for anything more than this from a college basketball game.
You really can't, right? All you can ask for is that, from an entertainment perspective, is that the game is close, and this one has delivered, and then some.
And I think this is going to be exactly what we see in the MAC tournament come next week, beginning Thursday. And it's just going to be a lot of teams in a dogfight where you really don't know who's going to win. Manhattan right now is probably the eighth or ninth seed.
It's just
and Quinnipiac's probably going to be the two or three.
Every one of these teams in the MAC is just scrappy and can win literally any game against their opponent.
Cam Young set to inbound. 10.8 seconds to go. Young finds Rigoni. 10 seconds. Rigoni gives it to Kelly. Kelly guarded by Abube. Kelly driving inside. Puts up the layup. It's blocked by Usillo. Manhattan's got the ball. And Rich Kelly fouls him. With 1.7 seconds to go, Manhattan has a chance to win it at the free throw line. And why was Rich Kelly not taking a three?
Well, I'm not quite sure. I think it might have taken too long. And then they decided to wait. And Brian, it looks like that could have been goaltending there on Manhattan. I think that was Usillo, but they didn't call it, and I don't think that's reviewable. And it was clear they were frazzled from the get-go off that inbound, and I think Kelly realized that maybe a little too much time is being taken off the clock and just tried for two.
So Tekai Green will shoot from the free throw line with a chance to ice it. makes the first. It's a four-point lead.
And the fans are heading for the exits now as, barring a miracle, Manhattan has pulled this one off on the road.
Tekai Green is second from the line. Misses. Cam Young will take a buzzer-beater shot. It's no good, and Quinnipiac has lost to Manhattan today to finish off the season. A 62-58 Jaspers win over the Bobcats.
Obviously for Quinnipiac, a disappointing loss against a team that, quite frankly, they're better than Manhattan, but we've harped on it so many times. In the MAC, anything can happen. They played the game Manhattan wanted them to play, and Manhattan was rewarded for it at the end of the day.
Absolutely fantastic game. We want to thank everyone who worked behind the scenes on this game. Our director, Jonathan Banks, and Kyle Lavasser. In studio host, MJ Baird. Jack Main behind the glass in the QAQ studios, and everyone else who's up here who has helped us along the way today. We'll be right back with our final thoughts on the game. Quinnipiac falls to Manhattan, 62-58.
The young men and women who become United States Marines come from our hometowns to become a part of something greater than themselves. This commitment represents the highest level of steadfast allegiance to the betterment of our communities, our country, and our Marine Corps. The journey will be one of the most challenging, but also one of the most rewarding. The few, the proud, the Marines.
So you see, son, good manners are important. Should I go through it again?
Yes.
Yes, please.
Yes, please.
Exactly. Always say please, thank you, you're welcome, and excuse me. Sit up straight, hold doors open, don't speak with your mouth full, keep your elbows off the table. Share your things, play nice, and generally treat others the way you'd like to be treated. Got it?
Got it.
And stop picking your nose.
Most parenting's hard to do in just 2 minutes. But 2 minutes twice a day, making sure they brush their teeth, is easier. And it could help save them from a lifetime of tooth pain. Visit 2min2x.org to find out more. A message from the Partnership for Healthy Mouths, Healthy Lives, and the Ag Council.
There's always a moment of truth where it's either put up or shut up. We were yelling our hearts out. Even in our weakness, even in our pain, we continued to push. I don't know where the pain went to, but all I know is that I had what it took. I am a United States Marine.
PFC Darrell Willis serves his country as a Marine. Will you? Visit Marines.com or call 1-800.
Quinnipiac falls to Manhattan 62-58. So it looks like Quinnipiac will be locked in to either the 2 or the 3 seed, depending on what else happens in the MAC tournament. Kevin, this was a fun one to end the season. Not going how Quinnipiac would have liked, but a good game.
Oh, absolutely. And from a broadcaster's perspective, as I mentioned late towards the game, all you can hope for is that it's good. And this was a slugfest. This was an absolute slugfest. You know, Quinnipiac got out and were figuratively punched in the mouth that entire first half. Manhattan just played a bruising game, as I mentioned many times, just stifled Cam Young, stifled Tyrese Williams, and forced Quinnipiac to make plays on the inside, of which they were not able to do enough.
Quinnipiac will head to Albany Thursday. They won't play until Friday or Saturday, depending on what happens. So they'll be either the 2 or the 3 seed, depending on everything else in the MAC.
And again, if you had told Quinnipiac before the season started that they would be locked into the 2 or 3, they would have taken it. And I think from Baker Dunleavy's perspective, this is a lesson that they've learned here. They can't take any game or any opponent for granted. And in the MAC tournament, you need to learn that lesson the second you step on the court.
For Kevin Higgins, I'm Brian Schwartz. And for everyone behind the scenes today working on this broadcast, we thank you. And we thank you for tuning in. For now, we'll send it back to the studios as we start the post-game show. You're listening to Quinnipiac Bobcats Basketball on the Quinnipiac Bobcats Sports Network, WQAQ 98.1 FM and Q30 Television. Again, for Kevin Higgins, I'm Brian Schwartz. We'll see you in Albany next week. Quinnipiac Basketball on QBSN.
Account. Get yours today, because someday...
Well, an eventful ending to the Quinnipiac and Manhattan game tonight. Final score, Manhattan wins 62-58 over Quinnipiac. Welcome to the Q30 Sports post-game show. It's part of our Bobcat Gameday production. You just heard from Brian Schwartz and Kevin Higgins, our play-by-play and color commentators. Now we have all your post-game show. We have players' reactions, highlights. We'll get to all of that. But first, let's look at what this game means for Quinnipiac. Of course, they lose. So here's some of the scenarios. Had Quinnipiac won, they would have locked up that 2 seed and a share of the conference title. But ultimately, the loss means one of two things. The Bobcats can either be the 3 seed or the 4 seed. Here's how that'll work. Quinnipiac will be the 4 if Ryder wins its game this afternoon, and Quinnipiac will be the 3 if Ryder Ryder loses its game. If we look at that score right now, Ryder is up 66-59 over Marist, 2.5 minutes left. So right now the Bobcats' seeding is in the hands of the Ryder Bronx and Marist Red Foxes. So we'll have to keep you updated with that as much as we can throughout this post-game show. But we'll also have some player reactions. We'll have Coach Baker Dunleavy in his live press conference. We'll have our beat reporter Josh Silverman up live at the bank, or at the People's United Center as well. Also looking at some live stats from today's Quinnipiac game. Look at the leading scorers for both sides. For Quinnipiac, it was Rich Kelly with 17 points, and Tyler Reynolds for Manhattan, he had 12. Kelly also had 4 rebounds to add to his line. Leading the Bobcats in rebound was Abdullahi Bundu, and for Manhattan, Takai Green and Abube Abube. So if we look at the MAC bracket right now, where things stand without all of these games yet completed, right now, Quinnipiac, as I said, is going to be either that 3 or 4 spot. We have them slated in at the 3 right now. But, of course, that will change if Ryder wins its game. As I said, they're up right now, but only by 5 points over Marist. So Iona's the 1, Canisius is the 2. Those are both final. Quinnipiac might be 3 or 4. That would leave Siena and Ryder up in the air as well. As for the rest of those teams, those may fluctuate based on what happens at the top of the standings as well. So we see right now St. Peter's is that last team. They're locked in. Fairfield's locked in at 10 as well. But right now, 4 through 9 will kind of be fluid in the next couple minutes as we try to bring you the updated scores from around the league. All right, we have Josh Silverman live after the game with his analysis. Josh, what's going on?
Thanks, MJ. We'll be joined live by Baker Dunleavy and senior Abdullahi Bundu in just a few minutes. Quinnipiac lost 62-58, as you touched upon, MJ. Quinnipiac will now be either the 2 or the 3 seed in next week in the MAC tournament up in Albany. And it was just one of those games where, look, you know, Quinnipiac lives and dies by the 3, and today was one of those games where they had stretches where they were able to get it, and Rich Kelly hit some big shots late. Ty Pickron had some 3s off the bench, but it just wasn't one of those games where the shots were falling enough for them. Manhattan did a great job of containing Cam Young and just forcing Quinnipiac into bad situations.
Josh, of course, this one kind of close as we came down the home stretch here. Manhattan was up at half, of course. Quinnipiac got it back, tied it up 54-54. For a while, we saw that teams exchanged 3-pointers. But what for you made the difference in the end?
You know, the difference in the end was Manhattan made their shots late. Quinnipiac missed some shots from the free throw line. They just missed shots. The last play was a 2. It didn't seem like they really were just connecting on what they needed to. Manhattan, again, the tough defense and a lot of energy, just forcing Quinnipiac into spots that they didn't want to be in. Manhattan was able to capitalize off their turnovers as well.
And Josh, you mentioned that 2-pointer there at the end. We're watching the game, and it seems like, you know, Quinnipiac calls its timeout, then Manhattan does. Was that the play Quinnipiac tried to draw up, in your opinion, or was it just a failed-to-execute situation?
You know, I'm not sure. We'll speak to head coach Baker and leave in a few minutes, and I'm sure we'll ask him about that. You know, to me, when you're down 3, I don't know why they went for the 2. Maybe the first look wasn't exactly there. We'll have to go back, and we'll have to take a look and see what, you know, see what the plan was on that, and we'll hear about it from head coach Baker Dunleavy.
All right, Josh, thanks. We'll send it back up to you once we have Dunleavy in the press conference room. But for now, back to a couple of those out-of-town scores quickly. Update you on the Ryder-Marist game. Again, this huge implications for that Quinnipiac game. Ryder is up 67-61, but I'm hearing Baker Dunleavy is approaching the podium, so we'll send it up to him.
Disappointing day for us. Obviously, you know, we've been playing good basketball. Obviously, on the road, you know, 2 straight road wins. Feel good about where we are. And I think the biggest takeaway is, you know, last game of the season. Really impressed the way Manhattan came in here and set the tone. Really, really, the game was played, I think, at their pace, on their terms, and they deserve the credit for that. Obviously, we could have executed at a much higher level. You know, one day's preparation probably didn't do a good enough job getting ourselves ready. Thought our guys battled like always, but just a little bit short today, which is disappointing for our seniors.
When Cam has had some trouble with getting open, they're doubling off him pretty much every time he caught the ball. What can you guys do to get him some easy looks and kind of get him going?
You know, we try to flash him into the middle and run muscle screens. You know, that's probably the 2 main things.
Coach, your team shot way better from beyond the arc in the second half. So what was the biggest difference for you from the first half into the second?
I thought we had more body movement, more ball movement. Yeah, I thought we were a little stagged at the first half.
Baker, what was the play call on the last play? Down 3 with 10 seconds left. Rich shot at 2. Was that part of the plan?
With that much, I mean, if we had a quick two, we could have taken a quick two, but that late, we probably would have wanted a three. They took away the initial option. He drove the ball. Best thing probably would have been the driving kick, but took what was in front of him.
Do you think an experience like that for a sophomore is good for him to learn from and just grow from it?
It's good. I think any experience you get, you got to grow and learn from. It's always more fun to learn from a win, but sometimes you're motivated more by the tough feeling you get in your gut from a loss.
Seemed like Manhattan in the paint was very efficient most of the game. What do you think it showed you on the interior that you guys struggled a little bit with?
Yeah, we struggled to throw up their timing in terms of their passes and their positioning in the paint, whether it be off drives or post-ups. And again, you give them credit for establishing kind of that's their game, and they established it.
Coach, what's the biggest thing you guys could take away from today going into the tournament next week?
Just, I think, 40 minutes. You know, like always, I thought we didn't have a great start to the game. I thought at times we did a great job responding and making runs. But that's how you play. You know, if you fall one run short, then you're going to lose a game. So just consistent effort and just kind of tightening up some of the details, especially defensively.
Baker and Robinson started the game on senior day today and then didn't really play until the final seconds. Was that part of the game plan?
Well, Tyree Pickron's been doing a great job. I thought he was really coming along, dedicating a little bit more minutes for him. It's just more of a feel thing. I thought he did a great job.
Anything else, guys?
Thank you.
So there's Baker Dunleavy after the game. We'll get a little bit with Aaron Robinson after his senior day as well in just a little bit. But first, we're going to send it back to the press conference. I'm hearing Abdulai Bundu approaching the podium. Let's have a listen.
What was that actual moment like, you know, walking out on the court?
I mean, it felt good. Bittersweet moment. You know, I tell myself, dang, I'm about to leave, you know. But at the end of the day, you know, walking out there, I realized, you know, sort of telling myself I'm about to live, just realize it's time. You know, you tend to outgrow places. You know, I loved every moment I've had here. I appreciate the growth, the learning I've had and received from everybody in this whole community. So, you know, it was a bittersweet.
Did you at any point during the game today that this would be the last time you'd be scoring a point and a rebound in this court?
To be honest with you, nah, man. I tend to play like that every day. You know, obviously it sucks that today is literally the last day, but, you know, it didn't hit me that much. You know, I just feel like it's a lot more basketball to go, to be honest with you. But, you know, definitely sucked to realize that, hey, that was my last free throw and all last layup or whatever here. But, you know, we got to move on.
What can we expect to see from the Quinnipiac Bobcats in the MAC tournament?
A lot of learning from here and growth. We just got to learn from today, to be honest with you. Today has to be what drives us through it, that whole tournament. Because at that point, it's life or death. And, you know, as you can see, you'll see what went on out there. It's a lot of stuff we got to work on. Not a lot, but, like, some primary key aspects that we got to work on in order for us to be able to make it longer in the MAC tournament.
Is this being your senior year, does that affect how you're approaching Albany or anything you might do differently?
I don't think so. I approached it the same in my freshman and sophomore year. Last year was the same way. You know, this year, honestly, I'm just going to keep going. You know, I've always prided myself in being a consistent player, you know, just knowing my role, leading the guys, bringing energy, doing what I do best to the best of my abilities. You know, there's no need for me to play desperate because I haven't been playing desperate all year. So why change now? You know, just keep going, keep being consistent.
Of the four teams you've been on, this team has probably been the most successful in the win-loss comp. What makes this group more special?
I mean, all the groups were special. They all had their own thing that they brought to the table. But I think with this group, you know, we're just a little bit together. And, you know, everybody wants to learn. Everybody wants to learn from each other. You know, we hang out with each other off the court. You know, we stick together no matter where we go. In the cafeteria, people see us sitting together. It's just this urge to just stay together and just learn, you know. And everybody has a positive attitude. You know, we mess up. We messed up a lot of times. And the guys are just like, you know what, come on, let's keep it together. We'll text each other individually. At some random point, one person will send like a long paragraph explaining the possibilities that we could do, or how much he loves us. You know, just what we do, man. We just stay together.
Anything else, good?
Yeah. That there, Abdoulaye Boundou, Quinnipiac senior, addressing the media after his team's loss to Manhattan. Quick update before we head to commercial. That Ryder game, which is ever so important to where Quinnipiac will finish in the standings. Ryder leading 69-62 with 43 seconds left in that game. Again, if Ryder wins, Quinnipiac will be the 4 seed in the conference tournament. If Ryder were to lose this one, Quinnipiac would rise to number 3. All right, we'll be right back on the Q30 Sports postgame show. Welcome back to the Q30 Sports postgame show. Quinnipiac falling to Manhattan. Final score today of 62-58. We have the first half highlights ready for you, I believe. Let's roll a tape if we do. Nope, we don't have the highlights yet. We'll get to those. Yes, we do. All right, jump right into them. Quinnipiac and Manhattan. It's senior day for the Bobcats. 4 seniors, including Aaron Robinson, wiping away some tears from his face as they prepare for their final home game at Lender Court. We'll take you to the first half. Rich Kelly down low to Abdoulaye Boundou for the layup. Again inside, Boundou again. 2 good passes there from Rich Kelly. Cam Young, deep three there. Quinnipiac up big early, 15-8 at that point. And then Ty Pickron getting in on the action, another three. Puts Quinnipiac up 20-15. Later, down low is Boundou again, working it good inside in the first half. But here comes Manhattan late in the second half. Three-pointer here. At one point, the Jaspers go on a 12-2 run to end the second half. There are two of those points right there as well. Quinnipiac trying to do something different late in the half, down low. That'll be an and one from the Jaspers. Kevin Marfo picking up a foul. So at the end of the first half, Quinnipiac trailed this one 29-26. We'll have the second half highlights for you in just a second. Again, to look at some of the stats from this game, Quinnipiac's leading scorer, Rich Kelly, was 17. Cameron Young had 16. As for rebounds, Abdoulaye Boundou had 7. Cameron Young, 6. Marfo had 5. We'll look at some out-of-town scores. Again, that Ryder game that's ever so important to Quinnipiac. 5, Marist 64. Again, that is a final score. So the Ryder Bronx will knock Quinnipiac down to the 4 seed in the MAC postseason. Ryder slides into number 3 as Ryder owns the tiebreaker over Quinnipiac. So if we look at the top seeds right now in the MAC tournament, it'll be Iona 1, Canisius 2, Ryder 3, and Quinnipiac 4. We'll try to get you those first round matchups as soon as we can. But we also have another game going on around the conference. That is Siena and Niagara. They're in overtime. Siena's up 7 with just 20 seconds left. So that game, no implications for Quinnipiac, but more implications as we funnel down farther along the standings. So again, the Bobcats are a 4 seed. Coming into this game today against Manhattan, they had a chance to solidify their seed as number 2 and even be co-conference champions. However, with the loss and the way the chips fell around the conference, Quinnipiac's going to be the number 4 seed. That'll still get them a first round bye in the tournament, but if we look ahead to who they're going to play, the number 4 seed will play the number 5 seed in that first round game. So depending on who that is, right now it should be Siena, but again, that could change depending on how things go the rest of the way. All right, we're going to take a quick break here on the Q30 Sports post-game show. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the Q30 Sports Bobcat Gameday post-game show. Quinnipiac falling to Manhattan today. We got the full highlights, so let's show them to you. Here we go from Lender Court. Senior day for Quinnipiac men's basketball. 4 seniors being honored before the game, including the Robinson twins, Abdullah Bundu, and what they call the adopted member of the class, Cam Young, who's actually a graduate student. All right, so first half of action, down low is Abdullah Bundu, working nice in the paint in this game. Cam Young pulls up from 3 deep there. So Quinnipiac leads 15-8 at this point, but Manhattan making a late first half run. That gets them 2 points there. Here's another 2 with the and one as well. So Ryder goes on a 12-2 run at the end of that first half. But here we are to the second half of action now, and things get a little bit closer. Quinnipiac in transition, Rich Kelly with a nice right-handed finish. He finished with 17 points on the day. A little later on, Kelly again, this time bangs the 3-pointer. Quinnipiac inching ever so closely to tying the score. Manhattan, though, striking back. 2 points under the rim there for them. And later, Manhattan corner 3 from Reynolds. Good. That puts Manhattan back up. But look at this one from Marfo. Get that out of here. Good block there from the Quinnipiac big man. Now some dueling threes. It's Reynolds for 3 on this one end. And then Kelly for 3 down this end. Exchanging threes they go. And then back down the other side, Manhattan again for 3. It's Reynolds. So some back and forth threes there. Here we're in the final minute. Cam Young in the lane gets fouled. He'll go to the line. Makes both free throws. But man, Quinnipiac still needing to foul, trailing by a couple points in this game. Later on, Rich Kelly, Quinnipiac down 3. They need to get a 3-pointer up, but Kelly looks to drive, gets blocked there. And basically, Manhattan runs out the clock. They make their free throws. Manhattan wins this game. Quinnipiac can't make the full court huck. And the Bobcats lose to Manhattan. Final score 62-58. All right, so we talked at the top of this show about the Quinnipiac season to date, how they got here. Let's have another look, though, now that the Bobcats have lost to the Jaspers.
They say every day is a new beginning, a new dawn. In Hampton, Connecticut, not only was 2017 a dawn, a new year, but really a new start. And there was a new vision, and it was clear it's time to win.
It's tipped out to the perimeter. Nelson at the buzzer. It's no good. The Bobcats pull off an incredible upset and take down Canisius 72-69.
And the Bobcats are going home.
If you keep good people around you that are honest with you and tell you the truth, you know, your staff, you can get better.
Fast forward to this year. Let's begin with one of the biggest games the program has ever played in. Opening up this season against the defending national champions, the Villanova Wildcats. That team Quinnipiac is trying to emulate. Baker's return to Philly wasn't the prettiest, but the Bobcats received high praise.
They're going to be good. Baker's got a good team. They got a lot of new guys they're putting together. They got good length, and I think they're going to be good.
The key missing piece for Quinnipiac that Saturday night in the city of brotherly love was Rich Kelly. The Bobcats' starting point guard would be sidelined for the first five games with an MCL sprain in his right knee. Five games later, Quinnipiac's new starting big man, Kevin Marfo, went down with a partially torn meniscus. Three games without him, 3-3 to start MAC play. Marfo returned January 25th against Marist, and he wasn't the only one to have the headlines that weekend.
Cam Young will go the other way for Quinnipiac. Young for three. There it is! Cam Young from downtown.
1,000 points, I never thought that would be something like coming from junior college, you know, having a startup, only having 2 years, I never thought it would be something I would get.
And then Cam Young decided this is his time to shine.
Cameron Young. He might have had the best performance of any player in a game this season. 55 for Young, third most by a D1 player in the last 20 years, most by anybody this year.
55 points, most in NCAA Division I basketball this season. Most ever by a MAC player in a single game. MAC Player of the Week for the fourth time. And the accolades kept on coming. Everything for Young. Dunleavy and the Bobcats is on the rise as the regular season sees its sunset. But it surely won't be the end. The postseason is coming. The sun will rise on the morning of the MAC tournament in Albany, New York soon, and it'll sure to be brighter than it ever has for Quinnipiac.
All right, as we conclude the Q30 Sports postgame show, we're going to send it up to Josh Silverman one more time at the People's United Center. He's standing by with Quinnipiac senior forward Aaron Robinson. Josh?
Thanks, MJ. I'm here with Quinnipiac senior guard Aaron Robinson. Aaron, thanks for being with me.
No problem, Josh.
So we talked a little bit during the week about the emotions leading up to senior day. We saw you getting a little emotional. What was going through your mind in that moment?
Just the rush of the whole 4 years that I've been here. You know, this whole day I've been kind of choked up walking through the training room. You know, there's pictures all in the training room of you know, the 4 years that we've been here and seeing everybody, you know, seeing obviously my teammates and just everybody. I don't know, you just kind of flash back and think of all the good times that you had over the past 4 years, and it just kind of catches you off guard, and then you just kind of get choked up. So that's what that was.
Is there one moment in specific that your mind keeps kind of running to, that you keep going back to, that you love?
More so, I think I would just think about my mom. Like, if she could have been here to see it, if she could have been here to see me and my brother, you know, on senior night. Just, you know, we've had a lot of family from Maryland come up and family from everywhere come up with us today. So just kind of thinking of her a little bit and what it would have been like if she'd have been able to be here to see it. But other than that, man, that was the main thing I would say.
And what did it mean for you to have that family come up from Maryland?
It meant the world, man. I think anytime you can have family, you know, coming such a far away to come see us play and come support us is definitely good. We don't get to see each other too often because we're up here for most of the year. So anytime you get to see them is good. But on a day like today, it definitely was meant a little more to have them with us.
And so not only is the season not over yet, but you'll also be here next year. But when you look back at the last 4 years, you mentioned going through the process with your brother and Abdullahi Bundu, you know, someone you're so close with. What are you kind of thinking about it in terms of just reflecting on the last 4 years?
I think just, you know, being able to, me, Drew, and Dooley, being able to come here together and then finish together. You know, we were recruited by Coach Moore, and, you know, I don't think any class that he recruited was able to finish. Like, everybody that came in came out together. So me, Drew, and Dooley talk about that all the time, just being able to finish where we started and, you know, just be able to hopefully put a banner up if in the MAC tournament if we're lucky enough. But I just think just kind of thinking about all the good over the in the dorms and in the locker room, on the court, off the court, just together. I think those moments are just precious, so we just kind of reflect on those.
And you mentioned the MAC tournament, which begins this Thursday up in Albany. What is the key for Quinnipiac to win the MAC tournament?
I think we just got to just lock in on little things, man, details. Like, there's moments where I think games can get away from us where we just kind of have mental lapses. So I think mentally we just got to lock in, you know, for a full 40 minutes. We talk a lot about, you know, full 40-minute efforts, you know. We'll go on stretches where we're playing really well, and then we'll go on stretches where we kind of, you know, have our lapses. So I think just mentally trying to put together a full 40-minute effort offensively and defensively and just try to control what we can control. You know, we can't really control necessarily when what shots go in or what shots don't go in, but just trying to control our attitude and how hard we play, you know, defensively, rebounding, and things like that.
All right, awesome. Thanks for your time. Best of luck in Albany.
No problem. Thank you.
All right, MJ, back to you.
Josh and Aaron, thank you very much, gentlemen. All right, so one final standings update for the Quinnipiac men's basketball team. We said before the Bobcats were a 4 seed, but actually upon further review of these tiebreakers, Quinnipiac's actually going to be a 3 seed, and here's why. They're tied right now with Ryder in the standings. The first tiebreaker is head-to-head. The team's split 1-1. But the second is the team's record against the top overall seed, which in this case is Iona. And Quinnipiac has a better record against Iona. So right now, Quinnipiac is going to be the 3 seed in the MAC tournament starting next week. Their first game will be in the quarterfinal round, Saturday night, March 9th at 7 p.m. That, of course, at the Times Union Center in Albany. Q30 Sports will be there with all your coverage of that game, all the shoot-arounds, all the media availabilities, the entire weekend, men's and women's from Albany. So check out Q30 Sports for all your coverage. All right, that's going to do it for the Quinnipiac Bobcat Game Day post-game show. Thank you so much, everyone, for your help on this today. For our producer, for all our producers, for our director, Jonathan Bank, our reporters up at the bank, Josh, Kyle, Kevin, thank you all. Thanks so much for tuning in tonight, guys. Quinnipiac falls to Manhattan 62-58 in the MAC regular season finale. The Bobcats will be a 3 seed in the upcoming MAC tournament and hopefuls for the NCAA tournament come late March. From the media suite, SC 125, I'm MJ Baird. Have a good night.